We only use the highest quality ingredients, then serve them up with all the energy and excitement of the big game packed into every bite. From our always fresh 100% USDA choice custom grind burger to Alabama's Gulf Seafood. And don't forget our legendary wings. There's something for everyone.
Every day is game day at Bombhouse, Victoryville.
Legendary fun, legendary food.
Family owned, family owned. Two of the different family nights. You know, Terry Thompson, Becky Thompson.
And when you come to Terry Thompson, we promise to always treat you like family. So for your next new Chevy.
Hello.
Okay, everyone, tonight is our Spina Bifida Awareness Game. You notice all the folks on the sideline, the end zone, and the yellow t-shirts. We like to spotlight our local Spina Bifida support organization by welcoming many families who are affected by Spina Bifida and by giving everyone here tonight the opportunity to participate in this great organization. This is the 10th annual Spina Bifida Awareness Game. We are blessed to have so many people in our community support this event again this year. We'd like to say thanks to Brett and Heather Horn for all that they do to bring this awareness game to be every year. If you want to find out more about Spina Bifida, you can visit SpinaBifidaAssociation.org to participate in tonight's fundraiser. This is a fundraiser event. You can visit the Spina Bifida tent at the north end of the end zone. You'll see it clearly marked. You can purchase shirts. You can purchase raffle tickets. We'll draw a winning raffle ticket and give that award at the end of halftime. Or you can participate in the silent auction, and throughout the game you'll see a QR code on the Jumbotron, and you can read that with your phone and find out more about how to participate in a wonderful silent auction. Great prizes from lots of great merchants in the area, people like Ola Parks, Mosley Meat Market, Starbucks, Jeans Beans, Eastern Shore Toyota, lots of great people, Fairhope Soap Company, Rotolo's, Ox Kitchen, Fantasy Island, Coastal Outfitters. I mean, there's just so many great sponsors who've stepped up to provide prizes for the silent auction tonight. So you'll want to go there and take part in that silent auction during the first half of the game. We will close that out at the end of halftime. So again, we'd like to thank you and thank all of those who are here tonight being a part of our very special Spina Bifida Awareness Game. Hope you have a wonderful time and a great event, and I hope that we can raise a lot of money tonight for this wonderful organization.
You know what I'm saying? That way they suck the soil. I'm on your palate.
I've had patients tell me that they, you know, were reviewing places to retire to, and they chose Fairhope because of Thomas Hospital and because of the physicians here in the community, so they knew they had excellent health care.
I love Thomas Hospital because of the friendly atmosphere.
It's, they can view it as a trusted friend or a place where they can have confidence and know that they can come and get a fair assessment.
We do see a lot of the patients that we take care of in the emergency room outside of the hospital, and they always come up to us and say thank you, and they're very grateful for the care we provide here.
The patients feel like they are part of our family too, because they don't feel like they're just a number.
Everybody's really committed to serving the community here. You can see that it's evidenced every day by what the staff does to go above and beyond the extra mile for taking care of patients, really meeting their needs.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to WC Majors Field here at Fairhope Municipal Stadium. And of course, this is the home of your Fairhope Pirates. On behalf of Fairhope Mayor Sherry Sullivan, the City Council and Recreation Department, and Fairhope High School Principal John Cardwell, we welcome you to tonight's game as the Pirates welcome our neighbors from the north, Daphne High School, their Trojan football team. Tonight is a regional contest. It is the rivalry game for the Jubilee Cup. Tonight is also our annual Hall of Fame game. We'll be inducting our 2023 class of athletes and associates into the Fairhope High School Athletic Hall of Fame. We'll do that at halftime. We'll be introducing those inductees during the first half as time allows, and we will again hold the induction ceremony near the end of halftime. Now the starting lineup for your Fairhope Pirates. On the defense tonight, on the line, number 29, Rock Your Heart. Number 40,
man, I can't stand. My head back to my bed. You know I'm pocket 10. But man, I got this way. Man, I got this way. When I surf, now I be surfing swag. I'm on hypnotic, not hypnotic. Like
And a big hand for Caitlin Horn. What a fantastic job. And if you think that's easy, you are welcome to volunteer for our next
one. We'll add him to fight to the flame.
Once again, Spina Bifida Awareness Night. The silent auction is happening right now. It's on. You can get in the action from the comfort of your own seats.
Good evening and welcome to Pirate Nation Live. Tonight, the Fairhope Pirates take on their arch rivals, the Daphne Trojans. You've got Jack Burrell tonight along with my partner, Dustin Wagner. Dustin, this is the first home game I've been able to do this year. I've done all the away games,
right,
but I'm excited to be here back at Fairhope Municipal Stadium watching the Pirates play live in person in my hometown. Man, set the table for us.
Well, man, it's good to be here, and it's my first home game this year too, which
how you
is really
like that
odd.
Echo? How you like the echo tonight?
Yeah, the echo's kind of weird. if I was singing the national anthem, it'd probably be good to have that echo, but since we're just talking, not so great. But I told Dez earlier, I didn't even recognize the big screen here that we have in the booth, and that's awesome.
But, yeah, it looks fantastic. When I was walking up, you know, along the sidelines, I looked up in the booth, and I saw that big screen, and I thought, wow, we're big time.
Yeah. Hey, what a beautiful night for a game tonight, yeah, especially against the Trojans here coming in town. Not a bigger game. Even though this year hasn't been what we thought it was going to be and what we hoped for it to be, it's still Daphne versus Fairhope. And Daphne comes into this game, Jack. There's still a little bit left for them, a chance to go to region, get into the playoffs. With us, it'd take a miracle for us to get into it as we are now with our standings.
Well, right now we just want to salvage the season and get a few wins to build some momentum for next year. But I'm going to tell you something. Last Thursday night, playing at Foley. And Foley's right. Got a really good team. They got a very strong team, big as always. I kind of think we turned the corner. We have an echo in our headset, so yeah. Every time I say something, I'm listening to myself, and sometimes I go astray. But anyway, I think that we righted the ship. I thought we looked really good. I thought that our quarterback play improved. I thought that our quarterback matured. Having Corey Martin back on offense adds mm-hmm. another dimensional. They're not so one-dimensional. So they threw the ball. They threw the ball long. They stretched the defense. And I look for more of that tonight. Now, I talked to our Coach Williams, our offensive coordinator, after the game as he was leaving the press box. And I said, Coach, I thought you played well. I saw a lot of good things. And he was upset, you know. And I thought, well, if you're not upset, then something's wrong with you.
Right.
But nonetheless, he'll reflect on that and watch the film and look back on a lot of progress that I believe the Pirates made last week. So I'm just excited tonight. I think that we're going to give Daphne all that they can handle, and I think there's a really good chance we're going to come out of this with a victory.
Yeah, I mean, I look for the coaches to have done something this week to prepare for a team that has scored 178 points this year so far. Their offense has really done a good job of moving the football, but their defense has given up some points. Us, on the other hand, we've given up 158 points and only scored 77. But as you said, Coach Williamson, I know that they put something in place to try to get us going tonight on offense. This is too good a coaching staff to not do that, and I'm excited to see what we got going on tonight on the offensive side of the football.
Well, and Dustin, you know, you talked about all the points that our defense has given up, and some of that is directly related to the fact that the offense is not producing more punts, more turnovers, giving the other team more opportunities to score against our defense. Because I think that our defense has played very good at times. It's just that they've spent too much time on the field. And against Foley, you know, they toughened up. At the first game of the season against Spanish Fort, the defense played tough. But if you remember, the difference maker was Corey Martin, who I mentioned earlier, who had not played since the Spanish Fort game. Mm-hmm. So we were 1-0 with him, right, and now we're 1-1 with him, but we played a much better game offensively last Thursday night.
Well, you know, if we can duplicate what we did last year, 26-7 at their place, that would make everybody here in Parrotland happy. So we hope that'll happen. You know, going tonight, some big games tonight, man. Baker and Mary Montgomery playing tonight. MGM undefeated.
Yeah, when's the last time that West Mobile rivalry had two undefeated teams? A coworker of my wife's, her son is a sophomore at Mary G. Montgomery and plays for Mary G. Montgomery, and she was talking about it to me just this morning. So they're fired up across the bay, and best of luck to both of them, and congratulations to both of them on being undefeated, because, you know, they've had some lean years there in West Mobile. Both of those teams have. And so it's, you know, it's good as a high school football fan to see both of them doing well. And it, boy, I tell you what, I'd like, maybe I'll get to see a replay of it.
Yeah, you know, a good chance for us, another way to look at this thing, we may not be able to make the playoffs, but you know what we can do? We can spoil the Trojans' chances and help spoil the Trojans' chances of making the playoffs.
Nothing wrong with playing the role of the spoiler.
No,
there's a lot of fun
exactly
in that.
Right. And when's the last time you saw MGM and Baker leading, like you're talking about, the region standings? It's been a long time.
Do you have those stats?
I don't have the stats, but I can tell you it's been a long time that Fairhope's been down at the bottom and MGM and Baker at the very top. And also Alma Bryant is right there, too, ahead of us, actually. That's who we will find next week is Alma Bryant. And then we'll get Baker, and then we'll get Briarwood to finish up the season.
Right.
So
a lot of left to go in this season.
There is,
yeah. And if we can't make the playoffs, we can certainly play the role of the spoiler. And like I just mentioned, that can be a lot of fun. And I'm going to tell you, do not overlook the Fairhope Pirates. None of those teams. I don't think any of those teams, even if any of them are better, none of those are head and shoulders above us. None of them.
No. And with this coaching staff, with Tim Carter as our leader, he's going to have them ready to play each and every week. And I'm telling you, if you sleep on the Pirates, if Baker comes in a couple weeks and sleeps on the Pirates, they're going to get their hearts broke. It's just what's going to happen. I see it, you know, in college football, you see it. You see it at the high school level. And you come in and sleep on a team, you better watch out.
I'll tell you three teams that just slept on it, and that was all the division leaders in baseball that just got ripped by the wild card teams because they went to sleep. And
wow,
the wild card teams who had been playing the previous week came in, and they keep that edge. And there's a lot, I think, to be said about keeping an edge. When you have a layoff, yeah, you get to rest. You get to work on those bumps and bruises that you have. But I think that you can lose your edge, especially at the professional level. It happens in NFL a lot. The teams that get the buys for a week or two, the teams that had to go through, if the wild card team happens to win and keep that edge, a lot of times they'll beat that division leader.
You're exactly right. And, my heart was – I'm a big Braves fan, and like the Dodgers too. And you talk about two teams that just laid an egg, especially the Dodgers, but the Braves just could not get the bats going.
Philly came in there. I know we're talking about baseball, but we're talking about sports. But the Phillies came in there swinging a bat as hard as any team I've ever swung a bat.
Oh, yeah.
Every single one of them were breaking their shoelaces every time they swung the bat.
Yep.
And they said Atlanta, who had a much better team on paper and a much better pitching staff, they just couldn't get it together.
No. What about Casino, Mike?
Yeah.
That's going to be fun. Casino night coming up?
Coming up October 29th. It's going to be at the James P. Nick Center. That's there on Bayou Drive. What's that?
It's the 28th.
Oh, 28th. I had 28th, 29th.
29th. Yeah,
get there a day late.
Yeah, that's right.
Blame Dustin.
You won't lose as much money that way.
Yeah. You won't lose it. So Saturday, October 28th, is $125 a couple, $70 a single. I think tickets will be available at the door. And you could go on to the Pirate Booster Club website and also purchase tickets. So anyway, go out, support your Fairhope Pirates. You know, have a chance to win prizes. What you do is when you're gambling for raffle tickets, okay, and you take those raffle tickets, and then you can win prizes with those tickets. You go in there, put them in the bucket of the prize that you want to win.
And guys, don't forget, you can donate and to these broadcasts for a fee. So just get on there at Pirate Nation Live and press the donate button. Like us on Facebook. Like us on Pirate Nation Live on Facebook. Do that over and over again. Also, don't forget, you can advertise on Pirate Nation Live. So over 75 live broadcasts in any Pirate sports season. So there's going to be plenty of opportunity for your business to be seen on there and get recognized and get some business here for the local community.
Well, if you want to advertise your business on Pirate Nation Live, and, you know, for instance, for this football game tonight, we'll have thousands of viewers for our broadcast.
Oh, yeah.
Get in touch with Desmond Joyner through our Pirate Nation Live Facebook page or our Pirate Nation Live website, which you can get to through the Pirate Booster Club's website. And get in touch with Desmond. Tell him you want to be a sponsor of Pirate Nation Live, and he'll get you set up. Tell him Jack and Dustin sent
That's
you.
That's right. So we I saw NBC here. Are we on NBC tonight or UTV 44?
I couldn't tell you. Worried about Pirate Nation Live, and I didn't see the other broadcast.
Yeah, I didn't either. I just know we're waiting on them on a commercial deal right now. If you're wondering what's going on, that's what we're waiting on. So
I couldn't imagine with Pirate Nation Live that anybody would watch any other broadcast.
Else.
I mean,
yeah,
but I'm a little biased, though.
Biased.
Just, if you don't believe us, just ask the Spanish Fort fans.
Yeah, they think we're a little biased. I don't know. Well, I don't think so. I mean, we do just wear pirate hats and pullovers. You know, maybe we are biased a little bit.
Well, we look through our blue and gold sunglasses occasionally.
That's right.
I think we try to be fair to the other team, and we give credit where credit is due. But we always pull for the Pirates.
Hey, y'all, don't forget to text in. Let us know you're watching us instead of 44 tonight. Watch Pirate Nation Live, 510-4496 or 605-1229. I don't know if they've got that. Yep, it's up on the screen. Text us. Let us know you're watching tonight. All right. Let's go, Pirates. There's the kickoff. It'll be a touchback. Really no wind to speak of tonight, Jack. Kind of calm out here, probably, 70 degrees?
Yeah, a little
just
bit lower.
Football weather.
I'll tell you, 69.
69, I was pretty close.
You were? I had the temperature on my truck on the way in, and it was 69 degrees.
Yeah.
So I was hoping it was just
a little bit.
I cheated a little bit. I did. Sorry about that. But I did bring you a hamburger, a hot dog, a Powerade. And I brought you some French fries, and I ate all of them.
I was famished. And I know you can't tell on screen looking at me, but I was definitely famished. I needed something to eat.
You look smaller than I thought you would look on the big screen up there, Dustin.
Yeah,
I thought
thanks.
You looked really good, man.
Yeah, man, appreciate it. You too.
I hadn't eaten a thing all day either, but I went down there to the cookout that they have down there behind the concession stand, and I ate everything that I saw, everything.
I didn't have time to go down. I got here kind of late. And did they have the good sausage fried stuff?
Of course.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Of course.
There's a good pass out to the outside.
Now it looks like Martin over there on the sidelines getting the first down.
Yeah, good pass there.
Yeah, Dustin, you're going to see a multi-dimensional offense from the Pirates tonight. I think you're going to be impressed, and I was really happy. And, folks, if you've been watching the games, if you didn't see the Foley game, you're going to see more dimensions from this Pirate offense tonight. Guarantee you.
Jackson Robinson, a quarterback, Preston Godfrey behind him in the backfield. Oh, good read.
Look at this.
Nice read.
Robertson on the keeper.
Good job.
What a play.
That's Martin right there. That's your
That's the way you run the option right there.
Yeah, that was good. The pitch was a forward pass, so if he doesn't catch that, it's going to be an incomplete.
I was worried that he was past the line.
Yeah,
it was forward. It was a forward pass.
Yeah, it was a forward pass.
But Jackson's definitely improving every game, and he's picked it up a level.
Yeah, that was a great read. Martin Kidd's really shifty, getting to the outside.
Makes a big difference on the offense and takes a lot of pressure off of Preston Godfrey, which not only confuses the defense, but it keeps Preston fresh, too. It doesn't put so much pressure on him. And it takes pressure off the quarterback as well.
Yep.
Big difference.
Direct snap to Godfrey. I was just looking at Kane, number 52, a senior, has 8 pancake blocks going into the game tonight, and he had one just 2 plays ago. Doing a good job on the offensive line.
Right. Our offensive line is not the biggest 7A line you'll see.
Right.
But they are quick, and they're smart, and they'll get after it.
Well, as evidenced by Alabama's offensive line, just because you're big does not mean you're great, because they have not been great this year.
Look at that.
Yeah, great run by Preston. He's going to be close to a first down. Looks like they're going to give it to him.
I have no idea how he got away.
Yeah, he just had that little jab step back and kind of got away from that tackle, and looks like he's going to pick up the first down.
I thought he made contact up the middle. Did he not make contact with somebody?
Yeah, I think he did. He just bounced back, kind of jab step
back.
He did,
just bounced off and
bounced it
peeled
out.
Around the right end and picked up a first down. They moved the chains again. Fairhope on the move right here early in the game. 9 minutes, 35 seconds left in the first quarter of play. From right here, I said it's the city of Fairhope Municipal Stadium, also W.C. Majors Field.
That's right. And Jodine Fieldhouse.
And Jodine Fieldhouse.
All right, first and 10. Split back. Good run.
And that's Godfrey. He picks up another first down. Yeah, they're going to give him first down yardage at the 35-yard line.
Desmond Thomas. That's Thomas.
Oh, it was? Okay.
Yeah, number 6.
You know, when they wear those black jerseys with the blue numbers,
them,
you cannot see them. It's very difficult.
We struggled really bad, guys, and, you know, be patient with us. We're going to try to call out the right numbers, but it's very hard to see those numbers. The royal kind of blends in with the black. Oh, we got motion. It's like somebody jumped on defense.
Fairhope pointing to
Daphne. They call it in Fairhope?
Of course, that's what you always do, though, when you're on offense line. You point the other way. And they're clapping, so I think they're going to be right. It's going to be an offside.
It's going to be offsides on defense.
Be first down and 5 at the 30-yard line.
Yeah, good to see Martin back out there. Definitely another weapon offense, which what we needed. They can't just sit there and key on Godfrey the whole time.
And that's what was happening a lot. And that's why the offensive production was down, and it's why the defensive was giving up a lot of yards, a lot of points. It's spending the whole game on the field.
That's right. But we didn't get a procedure penalty there on that motion. That's good.
Well,
early in the year, we were getting that every time.
Good takes it straight up the middle for about 2 yards.
Thomas coming back in. Second
and 4. They're going to call it 1 yard. Second and 4. And what you're going to see, Dustin, is they probably go up over the top some in this game.
Great, yeah, great call. I think that's a good. You'll have a short third down if you don't get it. So
right. They probably didn't want to run it on first and 5 because then it was a little obvious. It's pretty obvious now. We'll see.
Got 2 deep safeties.
No, a little swing pass.
He's going to get the first down.
Yep.
That's Godfrey.
I like that play. I like that play to Godfrey. Yes. And as long as he hangs on to that, he's going to pick up. He can lean forward. He'll fall forward for 2 yards every time.
Hey, credit to the coaches, man, making that move, putting Godfrey back at running back, let Jackson get back there at QB, trying to mix it up a little bit, find some way to get some momentum going on offense. And just credit to all the coaches and showing that they try to improve each and every week. Wow, they just shot a gap right there and got us for a loss. No chance for Godfrey right there to bounce it there.
Loses about 1 or 2 yards on the play.
Takes them back to the Daphne 25-yard line. 6 minutes, 50 seconds and counting. Boy, Daphne's got a big band over there on the other side of the field.
They do. They've taken always up got a good band.
Good bit of the stadium.
Their stands are filling up now. They weren't.
Oh, yeah.
Well, the reverse. It's open.
That's Amir Adams?
Yep, Amir Adams.
Holy mackerel. He barrels over somebody, goes inside the five. Probably going to call him down about the four-yard line.
This replay here, he gets over, gets a good block out there on the outside by Sanders. Sanders Daniel. And maybe even Jackson over there throwing a block as a QB. I think it was Jackson throwing a little nice block to spring it on the outside and setting Fairhope up in the red zone here inside the 10.
Well, he's a big kid, and he can throw a block, I guarantee you.
Just nothing doing there. Penetration by the Trojan defense. Loses a yard.
And it seems like when we have two backs in the backfield, we run the ball. And they're tee off on that
play. They could be. They could be picking up on something there on the defense.
I hope they're not watching the broadcast. I'm going to tip them off. But that's just something I've noticed. If I've noticed it, I'm sure their coaches notice it.
Right. He could be setting them up for something. Maybe a play action with the two. And trying to get them thinking
run. Up from what? At the four. Just get it in the end zone.
There's play action there. He's open.
He's open. He's wide open. He caught it. Touchdown. It's going to be a touchdown.
Good job. Nice pass. Ooh. Sparks about got the ref over there in the corner of the end zone.
I got an unsportsmanlike for catching the ref on fire.
Hey, watch this. I don't know if we got a replay. The old ref took a spark to the side of the head, I think. Oh, man. Hopefully it didn't go in his ear.
Was that Jared Jackson, number 7, on the catch?
I thought it was Sanders Daniel on the catch. I think, I don't know. I couldn't see the number. I mean, it's bad.
I thought it was a 7.
Was it 7?
But I don't think it was.
Could have been Jared Jackson. Was there a penalty? They're pointing to Fairhope.
They missed that flag, so the penalty
on the play is going to
bring the ball back. Chop block.
Chop block on Fairhope. Immature cannon blast by Charlie Langham. And Don Pippen. They just wanted to shoot the cannon out there. Gotta love those guys.
Oh, they have a blast.
Nobody does it more for Fairhope than Charlie Langham. And football. All right. So second and goal from the 22.
Get away.
Gain 1 yard. 2 yards.
That's Godfrey on the catch at 20. A long way from the end zone. I hate to see those points taken
inside
off.
The 20-yard line. It'll be third and 19. 19 for the Pirates.
Third and goal from the 19. I don't know if he's going to try to run a little swing pass, get somebody in space, or shift, try to get a mismatch. Maybe Sanders going across the middle. Nope. Oh, he's open on the post.
Wide open. You catch it?
Dropped
nope.
It.
In and out of the hands.
I'm impressed with this kid's arm.
I'm telling you, he's turned the corner. That was a big-time play right there.
I'm impressed with this kid's arm.
How good was that?
That was a great throw. You had to throw it there because the defender was right on him. You had to lead him.
He avoided the pressure.
He did.
He didn't get, you know, he didn't get freaked out. He just put the ball on the money. Maybe a little bit low, but it's still
still a
good
catchable ball.
A really catchable ball.
You had to put it out there for him because if you'd put it on him, there's a chance he gets knocked away or intercepted. He was that good of coverage, but.
Throw McKellar out for the try.
That's a good kick.
And the kick is good. And McKellar's foot's getting stronger with every game, too. No,
that
his foot
good.
Is getting kicker.
That looked good. It's good.
Getting stronger. There you go.
All right, Charlie. There you go. Charlie put some sparkles in it. He's ready.
Yeah, they got those streamers.
That old streamer's in
I'm glad we got some rain this week. Might catch the field on fire.
All right, our third inductee tonight into the Hall of Fame is Megan Dowdy Curry. Megan was a standout softball and basketball player for coaches Jonathan Heflin and Jessica Webb.
You get the chance to make a difference to that, not only to that patient in terms of providing them the care that they need, but also the family, helping them understand what's going on and have some reassurance that the patient's getting good care.
We all have something good to bring to the table to take the best care of our patients that we can.
It just feels like family. It feels like we're taking care of family while we're here.
Fairhope in general has grown a lot, and I feel like Thomas Hospital is the cornerstone for our community.
We're able, you know, to form those relationships with families and spend time with them, which is really special that I feel here.
Not only does our community give to us, we give back to our community. We want to be able to provide the care that they are looking for right here in Baldwin County.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
All right, we are back. Fairhope takes a 3-0 lead over the Daphne Trojans. 4 minutes, 26 seconds left in the first quarter. And Dustin, we had a touchdown call back because of a penalty. We had a drop pass for a touchdown, and then we had the McKellar field goal. And I thought that was a pretty good drive. We know we had the penalty that happens.
Yeah.
You know, it's just part of the game, but Fairhope looked pretty good.
Huh? They did. They did. It was a good job getting points on the board and a very positive drive for the Fairhope Pirates, opening drive.
Got a couple of shout-outs after the kickoff.
See what our defense can do here. Oh, little pooch kick.
Great coverage by the Pirates. Yeah, he loses a couple of yards on return. Quick shout out to Paul Davis is watching Pirate Nation Live. He said it's broadcasting on UT44, but not selling out. Good job, you guys. Thanks for watching, Paul. Appreciate it, brother.
Yep.
They're not going to give you a shout out on UTV either. So tell all your friends to watch Pirate Nation Live.
That was Donnelly, Kobe Donnelly, the wide receiver that returned that kick for Daphne. Jamar
that
Malone.
Looked like a little quick right there on the tight ends part. They didn't call it.
That was R.J. Daly, a little end around right there.
I just saw an event on the big screen that you might be interested in.
Uh-huh.
It's going to be at Mars Hill Church, and it said
food?
Tacos,
yeah,
and a mechanical bull.
Whoa,
so
wow.
The question is, do you like eat a bunch of tacos and then get on the mechanical bull? Because
oh,
that could get messy.
Oh, man, I don't know. Probably need to do the bull first. That's a good pass by Malone.
Malone on the pass reception for John.
Maybe it's a contest. How many tacos can you eat
without having a problem on the bull?
Yeah. Without losing it after you ride the bull.
Is there a weight limit on the bull?
You probably better look into
that. Yeah, we'll have to find that out before I go. Mars Hill. I hear that's a pretty good church.
I've heard that as well.
First and 10 for the Trojans. Looking to pass.
Ooh,
oh, they
great
call us
break up.
They didn't call us for anything, did they?
Nope.
Nope. No penalties. Good coverage.
I saw number 5. Was it number 5 on the pass breakup? Really hard to see those numbers.
Yeah, it's hard. Almost impossible from the front. You have to see the back. The back is easier to read than the front.
It might have been Nolan Phillips, number 9. It looked like a 5. It probably was a 9.
Man, Malone's going to pass again and run.
Oh, hang on. Oh, good job. Grabbed him by his shirt.
Yeah, great job. Great pursuit right there running down the quarterback by number 40, Patrick Harbin. His dad works at Ferguson and Daphne, and he's one of our salesmen. Saw him earlier this week, had a good talk with him. So that, good job by Patrick. 3rd and 3. That kid's big, Malone.
Yeah, he is. Mm-hmm. How tall do you think he is? He's stocky, so his height's deceiving.
Yeah, it is.
6 foot. Ooh, at least. He fumbled it. Get on it.
He's at least.
Hang on to him. Hang on. Don't let him out. We let him. Are you kidding?
Told you he was good.
Well, we had him trapped for a big loss, and he broke a couple of tackles and ends up picking up a first down. That would have been huge to stop them on their first series of downs.
Big time.
Phillips and Jensen made the tackle for the Pirates, the first down.
Nick Clark on the run.
All right.
10 yards.
Nick Clark.
Harbin again out there, Amir Adams.
And I thought Amir should have stepped up in there and met him a little quicker. He kind of let the guy come to him. And they'll juke you sometimes, and they'll get away, and you got to go up there and initiate the contact.
You're right. Malone looking to pass again.
He's got a lot of time. It's a good pass. It's on the money, and the receiver hauls it in. Big game for the Trojans.
R.J. Daly. So they're going to pass a little bit. Well, their right guard is big. Usually you see the tackle bigger than the guard, but the guard's a lot bigger than their tackle. First and 10. Ooh, Malone took a shot there, but he still completes the pass.
Daphne, just like that, is down inside the 5 to the 1 or 2 yard line of the Pirates, and they're on the move. The receiver bobbled the ball just for a second there and hauled it in. 1:26 to go here in the first quarter. Daphne looking to tie it up or even possibly take the lead. And that was a little too quick for me.
Here's a little Wildcat. He's going to take it himself. Untouched into the end zone for 6. Nick Clark. Well, there's no question what their game plan is. Put it in the air.
It didn't take them long to move down the field. We had them stopped on 3rd and 5 for a loss and would have put them in a punting situation. The quarterback made a great play, got away from the would-be tacklers, converted, and just a few plays later, punched it in the end zone to take the lead.
I tell you, I wish you guys could see the awesome setup we have for our camera that's pointing to us.
What is it sitting on? What kind of box
is
that?
A piece of cardboard.
All right, the point after is good, and Daphne Trojans take a 7-3 lead.
Let me tell you something. Y'all need to donate to Pirate Nation Live right now so we can get a stand for our camera.
Not okay, only that.
This cardboard box is, I tell you, Dez needs some help. This man is a genius. I mean.
We need some help with our headsets, too, because we've got this echo, and I don't know what I'm saying half the time. I'm listening to myself and
it's like the Twilight
scrambling
Zone.
My words, and I'm like, did I just say that or did you say that? I think I said something. I thought you said it. I was talking to myself.
Hey, sing something real quick with this echo. Let me see how it sounds.
What do you want me to do?
Sing.
Sing.
Yeah, with the echo. Let's see how it sounds. A little reverb.
Hey, look.
A little reverb.
No. You're the singer of the two. I've heard you karaoke. Yes. He can sing some country music now. He's a country music star. I dared him thinking, oh, this is going to be terrible, right? Dustin can sing.
Gambino's. I remember that night. Yep.
Josh had to get up there. I was kind of joking with you, and you just jumped up on the stage and knocked it out, dude.
Yeah, I'm not going to brag, but I've done a little bit of singing through the years, not just on karaoke, but.
Yeah, you do some backup.
It's fun.
Backup singer for Jason Aldean or what?
That's for another day. A lot easier than plumbing, I can tell you that. This has been a rough week. for Plumman.
You
all about rocket science, but it's been a rough week for Plumman. How's the rocket science been this week?
Why has it been so rough for plumbers?
For not all plumbers, but
for yours?
Yeah, it's been tough. It's been some things that typically don't happen have happened this week, but it's okay. We're going to get over it and keep going. Just like Fairhope's going to do right here on this drive. He wanted to take it out of there.
When's National Plumbers Week coming up? Do y'all have one?
If we do, I don't know when it is.
Yeah. Yeah. They don't have National Rocket Science this week either. No,
really?
Not yet. Yeah, but I've been lobbying for it.
Well, you got the 4th of July, stuff like that, you know, Independence Day. That's got kind of a lot to do with rockets.
Well, now you can just put multiple holidays on the same day. Just pick any Monday of the year and just add your own personal holiday.
That's right.
Just do it.
That's right. We got a camera running down the sidelines. I guess he's going to get an interview with somebody. He has got to be out of breath. Coming down. Fox 10. We got everybody here tonight. All right, Jackson Robertson looking to throw himself. Ooh, he had him, Jack.
Yep.
Martin was wide open across the middle.
I think that he didn't want to throw it in front of him because of the defender, though, because he threw it behind the receiver.
Back shoulder, maybe?
Yeah, and the defender reached back and got a finger on it. If he had put it where it was catchable, it may have been an interception. So,
right. So that's Nolan Phillips running some patterns tonight. You notice that? He's playing both ways.
Look at this. It was a smart move by the receiver that was out there trying to block. That couldn't get in front of the defender to make a good block, and he's upset with Sip. He made a smart play, though.
Dr. Coleman's supposed to be watching tonight on Pirate Nation Live, so I know that's one we got watching.
Well, we got Paul Davis's good buddy
that's
watching,
right,
too. Maybe they're watching together. I don't know.
They may be.
Dr. Scott, just let us know.
3rd and 7. Let's get this right here. Nope. Mm. That wouldn't have got it, even he caught it. Nope, maybe it looks like somebody ran the wrong pattern. He was talking
to Sanders
there.
Yeah, I was going
to
say, that's not going to pick up a first down if you're going to catch it on the sideline short of the down marker.
They probably have a little talk with him here.
Mm-hmm. You got to have some field awareness. It's a coaching moment, right?
We got Sanders punting. Or is that Nolan? I think that's Nolan.
That's a good punt.
He's down at the 50.
Yeah, he returns it about 11 yards to the 50. Daphne's going to have good field position for their second possession of the game. There's 14 seconds left to go in a pretty fast first quarter. Two possessions for Fairhope and only one for Daphne. 7-3. Looks like that we'll probably run one more play and then they'll switch sides of the field, which won't be much if they can hold them for no gain. They'll just flip the nose of the football around.
Yep.
They're right on the 50.
So tonight they're going to recognize, I see the 84 and 83. 85, 83 and 84.
83 and 84
state championship baseball teams tonight.
Now, kind of a ticky-tack call. They didn't make it, but if they'd been looking down the line, the Daphne receiver was running towards the line when the ball was snapped instead of running straight.
He's done that a couple times. You're right.
He's ran in about a yard or two.
Yes, he is.
And that's a little bit more than you should be able to get away with. If you just can't run a straight line, that's okay.
That's right.
But he was clearly running towards the line of scrimmage.
That's right. You're correct.
All right. Do we have time for a commercial, Des? All right.
Baseball team. These were our back-to-back state champions.
What makes Thomas Hospital special? Our team. Our team makes us so special. We have great physicians,
great staff and great volunteers.
We serve a lot of needs. We impact a lot of people. Baldwin County is the county everybody wants to live in.
People, when they talk about Thomas, they talk about the experience. They talk about how well we interact with the families. And I just think it's a wonderful place to be.
Over the years, I've come back to Thomas Hospital because it feels like a family. Thomas Hospital is a family-friendly environment who cares for you all the way from the time you're born all the way to the end of your life.
My favorite thing about working here at Thomas Hospital is the underlying attitude of the staff, where there is an understanding that we're all kind of looking out after each other.
We celebrate all of you guys. Welcome to the Hall of Fame.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
All right, we want to give a big shout out to the state championship Fairhope Pirate baseball teams from 1983 and 1984. Fairhope soon to celebrate their 100th year as a high school. And in the 100-year history of the high school, those are the only two state championship teams in baseball. We've had some awesome, awesome baseball teams. We've been in the state finals many times, but those are the two that brought it home with the state championships, and they did it in back-to-back years.
Yeah, my son's junior year, we went to the state championship. We were in the final game. We lost to Oxford 7-6. I think we were ahead 6-2 in that game, but we ended up losing the game.
I was there.
It was
in Montgomery.
God, it broke my heart. Yes, and that would have been
the Biscuit Stadium, right?
That would have been the third Montgomery. One. Yeah,
I went to all those games.
Really?
I did.
Yep.
Sure did. I rode up there with Clarence Bishop, or he rode up there with me.
Yep. That was a heartbreaker.
But I'm gonna tell you what, they had a heck of a baseball.
Oh, they did. One of the pitcher that pitched against us in the final game, he's pitched for the Braves this past year and the year before, and he's been on a couple different teams.
Yeah.
But
they had about four D1 signees on that team.
Yeah, they did.
And they probably had three or four guys that were 6'5" or taller starting on that team.
The first baseman.
The pitcher. The third baseman, I believe. And then they had that really stocky center fielder that was the coach's son, and he was a beast. Yeah.
Well, you remember the Garrett kid out of Foley? You know, he pitches for the Marlins now.
Right.
If you ever see a Garrett playing for Marlins, that kid's from Foley. His dad coached
a lot of kids from South Alabama making Major League Baseball.
All right, that was Malone right there on that run.
Got a kid from I want to say Loosedale, Mississippi, starting pitcher for the Phillies, I believe.
Really? Mm-hmm. They've got a heck of a pitching staff at the Phillies. Man.
Yeah, this guy played in the minor leagues for about 10 years and then finally had a breakout.
There's Malone going deep. That's a push-off.
Well,
we got
they
a flag.
Didn't throw the flag back there. The flag's back here in the defensive back around the air of the linebackers. Lyman downfield, maybe? It is.
It is. Good Look call. Legal man downfield. Back him up.
Give us a shout out if you're watching the broadcast tonight. We'd love to hear from you. Richie Hamilton in Nashville. Are you watching?
I got somebody texting in.
How about the Carnivales?
I haven't got anything from them yet.
How about the guy from Million Dollar Lakes? Where has he been?
Yeah, we haven't had them. Parker Glaze, offensive tackle number 75, said, have we seen him? 6'7", 225. Going to be someone to watch next year. All right. Good pass by Malone. Oh, and good tackle. That's going to save about 20 yards, maybe a touchdown.
Who was the quarterback? Was that Preston?
What do you mean? The corner?
The quarterback for us. Was that Jackson?
No, that's Amir Adams on that side.
That threw the ball?
Huh?
Who was our quarterback on that play?
That's not us. They've got the ball.
Oh, they do.
Yeah. Are you okay?
No, I'm not. The same color, and I'm thinking white jerseys. They swapped into the field.
Yeah, that's what it is. That got you. They swapped
Holy
it in.
Mackerel.
And
no wonder.
Hey, wake up over here. I was like, what are you talking? Huh?
I got the talk, and they swapped ins.
That's funny.
Oh, wow.
I thought Scott Berry was up here with me for a second. Scott, if you're listening, I'm just playing. I love you, man.
Hey, I was even rooting for him.
All right, second and seven. Oh, and he's across the middle. Oh, picked.
Intercepted.
Good job by the – who is that? Was that Nolan? Let's see right here. See the safeties backing up, reading Nolan. The eyes of the quarterback. Sees it.
See the number right there.
High points.
Yeah, that's number nine.
Is it Nolan, isn't it?
It's number nine.
Yeah.
Nolan Phillips.
Nolan Phillips on the INT. Stops at Daphne Drive, deep in our own territory.
I sure am glad you got that straight before we made that interception.
Yeah. All right, Daphne's got the ball on the one-yard line. Coming back the other – oh, no, it's Fairhope. It's Fairhope. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
Did you see that helicopter go by?
Yeah.
Those guys.
The helicopter just went by with a bunch of paratroopers jumping out. I don't know. You didn't see it? No, Desmond's looking. This is fun. All right. Come on, Jackson. Not much doing, Jack, up the middle.
Wow. That was almost a safety.
Yes. Not much doing up there. They're getting penetration in the middle.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
You almost want to get under center here and just get it off the goal line.
Over right tackle over and over and over last week against Foley with big success. And knowing they probably watched the game film, maybe they don't want to go to that too much. But right. I would have expected to see that a little bit more tonight.
Jackson in his own end zone.
Yeah.
So we got a penalty.
Well, it may be a procedure call. We're on talking us. About a guy
oh, yeah.
running forward.
Yeah.
When the ball was snapped, just what I was saying they did earlier.
They got it on us.
We just did the same thing.
I think we just did the same. They got us.
Probably. I hope I'm wrong.
It looked like the flag was beyond the line of scrimmage, though. It wasn't a line judge, I don't think. I thought it was a back judge that threw the flag.
I hope you're right.
You can't go any further back.
No, half the distance is half of nothing is nothing.
Yeah.
So.
I think you're right. I think it
That's
was on
it.
Us.
Procedure.
Yep.
Call it both ways.
Yeah, exactly. Before you mentioned it earlier, I had noticed that receiver doing that, and I'm glad you brought it up because –
I'm
I think he's playing for the USFL.
You notice that?
Well, you are.
I don't know.
You don't
know
which one's
playing
on
offense or defense, but I'm right. 2-for-2 on the calls.
Yep. That one sailed on him a little bit. Jackson didn't quite step into that. He had a little pressure and was on his back foot, and that ball kind of took off on him. Third and 11. I don't know that you try to do anything crazy here. Just get, make sure we don't have a turnover and just maybe punt this thing away and see what coach decides to do.
All right, third down to 11. If we don't get a first down, we do need to get 4 or 5 yards just to give the punter a little bit of room.
Oh, we got a penalty. I think we made him jump. Yep. Get us off the goal line there.
You are correct.
So it'll be third and 6. A little more manageable. Got a shout out from Mike Bolden. And obviously I put my foot in my mouth. He said that I told Briley, his daughter, that I said something to her stepdad, and she says, well, I don't have a stepdad. And anyway, he's got some laughing faces. Go Pirates. I love you, man. Thank you for pointing that out. Oh, Jackson run for his life. He's going to be sacked for a safety. Oh, did he fumble that?
No, safety.
Okay. I was hoping he didn't fumble it. Just rolling around in the end zone. I was afraid of that.
And with 9 minutes to go in the half, Daphne takes a 9-3 lead, and Fairhope will get a free kick and kick it back to Daphne. You know, as much as you don't like to see that, you never know what could happen. You get better. They're going to have worse field position. If we kick from the back of the end zone, a lot of bad things could happen. And you could
block it,
fall down. You still get the safety. They could get a touchdown. They're going to have good field position. But now with the free kick, at least they won't have, theoretically, until they kick, won't have as good a field position. Mm-hmm. Had we kicked it off the back line of the end zone.
All right, guys, we're going to commercial. We'll be right back.
Our next inductee into the Hall of Fame is Hannah Legg. Hannah was a swimmer for Fairhope High School for 5 years and is currently an assistant coach with the Fairhope High School swim team. She is our first swimmer inducted into the Athletic Hall of Fame. Hannah was an exceptional swimmer, which was built on her hard work, her commitment and hard work and dedication.
I've had patients tell me that they, you know, were reviewing places to retire to, and they chose Fairhope because of Thomas Hospital and because of the physicians here in the community, so they knew they had excellent health care.
I love Thomas Hospital because of the friendly atmosphere.
They can view it as a trusted friend or a place where they can have confidence and know that they can come and get a fair assessment.
We do see a lot of the patients that we take care of in the emergency room outside of the hospital, and they always come up to us and say thank you, and they're very grateful for the care we provide here.
The patients feel like they are part of our family too, because they don't feel like they're just a number.
Everybody's really committed to serving the community here. You can see that it's evidenced every day by what the staff does to go above and beyond the extra mile for taking care of patients, really meeting their needs.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
All right. Once again, thank you to our sponsors, Thomas Hospital and Alpha Urgent Care. Fairhope now kicking off. It's not a free kick. They let them put it on a tee in high school.
Big block.
Yeah. When he's got a little seam.
We got a penalty.
And we missed the angle.
Then we got a block. Oh, he's mad. The 45. I think it was on him.
He's the one that scored a touchdown. I think he's just fired up.
He may be. But it's coming back.
Yeah.
8:53 to go in the first half. Big run back by the Trojans there. But I think holding.
I do have Richie Hamilton, our friend from Nashville that always watches the broadcast. And he said he has a first cousin that he really, really loves. He's so short, you can see his feet in his driver's license picture. He's got a real sense of humor.
He must be a puppet.
Now, Marley's parents watching from Atlanta tonight. Her brother flew in from Florida to attend the game and said, go Pirates.
You got the Davises watching in Theodore tonight. Good to have them. Thank y'all for tuning in. Bo and Rhonda.
Got Jamie Garner tuned in. I don't know if he's in Fairhope or Auburn or Stapleton or where he might be tonight. Where are you at, Jamie? He was texting Scott and Cecil.
Is he a bow hunter?
No.
Starts in the morning.
No, sir.
All right, Malone back there. First down and 10 for the Trojans.
A little play action, rolls it out, sets back up.
Got some score updates for you. Mary Montgomery early up 14-7 against Baker. And Foley getting on Alma Bryant pretty good, 14-0.
Wow.
A couple updates. Mary Montgomery's been averaging about 40 points a game this year. All right, we got a penalty on Daphne again, backing them up.
Penalty against the Trojans will be marked back to their 33-yard line. Line of game is about the 48.
First and 15. Five wideouts.
It will be first and 15 for the Trojans.
Kid can throw it. I can definitely see why they're running this type of offense with this kid at quarterback. Got a good arm and can escape the pocket. Second and seven for the Trojans. Looks like we're going to bring some pressure here. Oh, when they get through it.
Yeah. When they get past that defensive line, they get a lot of running room.
Yeah, we walked the linebackers up and brought pressure up the middle, and he hit a seam in the outside the C gap right there on the right side and just took off. I don't know if I've ever seen a zero. CJ Gardner. Seen double zero, I guess.
I got Dawson Padgett looking to graduate from Fairhope High School this year. Glad to give you a shout out tonight. Thanks for watching the broadcast.
That is Mikael Willoughby.
I got Brian Kane watching with some friends from Juneau, Alaska.
Wow.
Says he's showing them some real Southern Friday night lights. And let's rally. Go Pirates. Thanks for watching tonight, Brian. And welcome to your guests from Alaska.
I'm assuming that's one of the Kane kids that's playing offensive lineman here. He's got 9 pancake blocks this year, 1 tonight.
I don't think his are that old yet.
You don't think it's one of them?
I don't think so. And they'd probably be at the game. Yeah, I think he'd be at the game.
I'm not a family member?
It may be a family member, yeah.
Juneau, Alaska.
That's the capital, you know. Yeah. Capital of Alaska.
Third and – it's a big third down here for Fairhope. 7 minutes to go in the first half. Need to stop them here. They're not in field goal range. Maybe 4 down territory on the 39.
Oh, yeah. Huh? I think so.
Think so?
With the way their offense has been throwing playing the football, and the way their defense has been playing, if they don't get it, they're in 2 down territory for sure, unless they take a big loss.
Ooh, 5-yard penalty.
Or they get a 5-yard penalty. Yeah. Sorry, I'm still pausing when I talk because I'm hearing myself.
5-yard penalty against the Trojans brings it back.
So that's going to make it 3rd and 11.
I did not stop off at the Fairhome Brewing Company on the way to the game. Brian is one of the owners.
Right by there.
He's one of the owners, one of the guys we can shout out to. So, yeah.
Malone looking deep. He's going to throw. Oh, he's got a guy wide open.
Well, I'm glad
busted
that wasn't
coverage
an accurate
there
throw,
for the Pirates.
You can't get any more open than he was.
No, that was a busted coverage right there. Yep. Nolan or somebody has missed that one. Somebody was supposed to have deep third, and they did not have it.
And they are going to line up to punt.
Yep. Got Martin deep.
And I think that's the call. It's a 4th and 11.
Oh, man, I thought we were about to get it.
Oh, no.
They didn't call a penalty. They didn't throw a penalty?
Yeah,
no,
he threw it. That's going to be a roughing call, too. Did we touch the ball down here? No.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, it's going to be
a – it's going to be a first down. Down.
Yeah, oh, yeah. It's going to be roughing. He ran into him, but he ran into him pretty hard. Yeah.
I hope the kid's okay.
We both thought he may have got a hand on the ball.
I thought he got a hand on it. If he did get a hand on it, then it's not going to be roughing.
Right.
They're talking about it right now. the back judge, the referee actually threw the flag.
Well, the guy standing directly beside the kicker dropped it. You'd think that if he did block it partially that he would know.
Right. It took him a while to throw it. Did you notice that? He waited until he was kind of laying there, rolling around before he decided to throw it.
Nathan Morella.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker. Oh, they offset. We got a block in the back. Two penalties, so it'll replay fourth down.
Oh, wow. And that's a break for the Pirates for sure.
Let's go get it again.
So we were talking earlier, they got a safety, but it turns out we're going to get the ball back. And
true. We picked up field position.
We picked up field position, yeah, absolutely.
6:45 to go in the first half.
And they're going with the backup punter.
Oh, they are. That's not the same kid, is it?
Nope.
And the snap was low. Kid made a good play on the snap, on the previous snap. Let's see how this snap is.
Yeah, if you've never punted in a game situation there, it can be stressful.
There's a snap is high. Good catch. Got a fair catch call.
Yeah.
15-yard line. Martin on the fair catch.
Yeah, that's a great fair catch right there. Mm-hmm. A gutsy catch. A lot of times they back away, but that's the way you do it.
Well, if the ball hits there and rolls, it's probably not going to make it to the end zone, but it's probably going to be on the 3 or 4 yard line.
Yeah.
So good job.
I like that result a lot better than what it could have been.
You ready to go to commercial, Desmond? He's out there.
All right, Desmond, if you want to keep your job, you get that commercial going.
You get the chance to make a difference to that, not only to that patient in terms of providing them the care that they need, but also the family, helping them understand what's going on and have some reassurance that the patient's getting good care.
We all have something good to bring to the table to take the best care of our patients that we can.
It just feels like family. It feels like we're taking care of family while we're here.
Fairhope in general has grown a lot, and I feel like Thomas Hospital is the cornerstone for our community.
We're able, you know, to form those relationships with families and spend time with them, which is really special that I feel here.
Not only does our community give to us, we give back to our community. We want to be able to provide the care that they are looking for right here in Baldwin County.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way health care is delivered on the coast.
All right, we're back in Fairhope with 6 minutes 38 seconds to go here in the first half of play.
First down for the Pirates.
We'll look to take the lead on this drive, potentially.
Martin spun down right there.
Lost on the play. And second down for the Pirates. After retiring from his baseball career, Toby Thomas volunteered at Central Alabama Community College with his father.
Talk about Toby Thomas right now on the stadium announcer, Mike Ball. He was on that team that we won the runner-up state championship the year we were runner-up. Played second base and pitched for us.
To our last athletic inductee, Toby Thomas.
What year is the Martin kid?
You have a penalty flag on the play.
Who's that?
Martin.
He is a sophomore, I believe.
Yep. No sophomore slump for him.
No. Not at all. As long as he stays healthy,
yeah,
he's going to be a real difference maker.
Just can't get anything quite going on offense right now. Second down and 13.
And we haven't thrown that deep pass yet. I'd like to see us go deep, stretch that defense. Maybe they don't feel like there's a lot of time back there to do it. But
they're going to rough on the quarterback here.
Yep.
Pass is incomplete, but we do have a penalty.
He's throwing his hands a lot. I didn't do it, but that almost certainly means I did it.
We got a face mask? Let's see. Personal foul, roughing the passer. 5 minutes, 46 seconds to go in the half. Our best play of the second quarter just happened. 15-yard penalty on a roughing the passer.
Yeah, so if you just joined us, Fairhope drove down the field, had a touchdown call back from a penalty, held on, got a field goal, took the lead early, and Daphne came roaring back and got a touchdown real quick of their own. And then since then, they've gotten a safety, and that's been all the scoring. 9-3, Daphne.
That's Godfrey in motion. They're just going to try to get out to him. He had open field in front of him, too.
Yeah. If he could have found a way to get the ball past the defenders. And it was a difficult task.
Oh, yeah.
He would still be running. He'd probably ran all the way up into Jodine Fieldhouse.
He had 20 yards of open field. Yep.
At least.
You got to drop down into that Josh Allen, Patrick Mahomes sidearm throw there.
I was thinking about that Patrick Mahomes sidearm.
That's what he would have done. He'd have just dropped it down, sidearm underneath him. Oh, coach took one on the knee.
Well, Alpha Urgent Care is open right now.
That's right. Home of the $30 physical.
Theoretically, if the Daphne coach gets his leg broken, can he go to Alpha Urgent Care or Thomas Hospital emergency room?
Yeah. Third and three.
Because he got rolled over there pretty nasty.
Yeah,
I've seen that happen. A lot of coaches with broken legs.
Yep. I guess the play clock was running down and Jackson noticed it, called timeout.
We got third down and three with 5:34 to go in the half.
We have two associate members being introduced tonight.
All right, we got another
supported the Pirate
UTV 44 commercial. How about the home of Pirate Nation Live, El Mexicano?
Yeah. Huh? Anybody watching tonight from El Mexicano?
I hadn't heard anybody text in yet, but Scott Berry is usually up there watching the game. I don't know if he'll maybe text in. He's texted in a couple times from up there with a little group of guys, people up there watching. But I'd say there's no other better place to go get you a fine margarita than El Mexicano.
Huh?
Three big screen TVs with Pirate Nation Live on.
Oh, yeah.
Jose doing pretty good up there.
I get up there, I start off with the queso dip. And a good thing that you get all those chips, you know, for free, because I eat about 20 pounds of chips and have to order a bowl or two of queso.
Yeah.
Get a couple of enchiladas, and then I get a couple of tacos,
right? It's good stuff. I love their chimichangas. Really good.
Family owned. Family run.
Yes, it is. One of his sons works up there with him for sure. And the mom. And just a great place to go if you want some authentic Mexican food. That's El Mexicano here at Fairhope.
It's a Fairhope tradition. No doubt about it. I've been going there for over 20 years myself.
We thought we were about ready to go live, and the commercial guy with the red hat is still standing on the field. Now he gives a thumbs up.
Well, you know, Pirate Nation Live made you to get out there and hold it up to get in a commercial, right?
Yeah. I'll get you a red hat. Get out there.
Yeah.
You look good in a red hat. Put a little A on it.
I knew where you were going. I got it. I got it the first time.
Yeah. Oh, he fumbled.
Oh, no, he fumbled it. He fell back on the ball. But a missed opportunity there on a third and short.
Ball hits the ground.
Yeah, Thomas was kind of upset right there. I don't know if Jackson was supposed to pull it or if he was supposed to give it to him, because Thomas looked like he thought he was going to pull it and just kept going.
Fourth and seven.
Fourth and seven. I think Coach Carter thinks he's just going to punt it, not turn it over him. Our own 31-yard line with 4 minutes and 50 seconds left to go in the half. Good snap. End-over-end punt. Almost hit a Daphne Trojan. Ooh, yeah. That was close.
Let's give a shout out to Bayside Orthopedic Sports Medicine and Rehab Center. You know, they were founded in 1977 in Fairhope, Alabama. Bayside Orthopedic has four locations now: Fairhope, Foley, Evergreen, and Bruton. With state-of-the-art orthopedic care provided through their five orthopedic surgeons, Dr. Greg Terrell, Dr. Joey Carter, Dr. Jay Savage, Dr. Trevor Stubbs, Dr. Baird, and Dr. Jason Dieterman. Is that five or six? Two, three, four, five, six. All right, we got to update this script. They also have an excellent physical therapy department, all in a beautiful facility at Greeno and Gaffer Extension. It's an exciting time in Baldwin County for to be a young athlete. And wow, this echo is killing me. With many fall sports in full gear, we are excited to be a part of the action. We are fortunate to be able to help to provide services for the children in the community who need our help getting back on the field, court, or pool. Visit their website at www.baysideortho.com or call them at 251-928-2401. Tell them, Dustin.
There you go.
Nation Live Center.
Holding on the Trojans. Back them up first and 20. 4 minutes, 35 seconds to go in the half. Fairhope down 9-3. Turnover will be really good right here. Single high safety, probably man-to-man coverage here.
Get him. Oh, good play by the quarterback to get rid of the ball. He was just about to get sacked.
He took a lick.
Yeah, short game. Yep. I got Luke Olive. He's tuning in from Disney World, and he says, go Pirates.
Wow. Tell Mickey and Minnie we said hello.
About the 34-yard line of the mark.
If they can hear us. I know they're probably pretty old now. I know they got some hearing aids or something.
Get credit for that. Clark again on the carry.
All right, it's going to be third and long now. 3:37. Guard. You know, I was debating, did Fairhope run the clock or did they give it back to Daphne with plenty of time in hopes of stopping them and getting the ball back with them having enough time? Right. And, anyway, that penalty to start off that drive was huge. If Fairhope can stop them right now, they'll get the ball back with plenty of time to score.
We've got a young man from Fairhope High School looking to graduate this year from Fairhope named Dawson Padgett. Said, please give me a shout-out and mean the world to me. So, Dawson, thank you for watching, buddy.
You know, Dawson, I tell Dustin every game that he never listens to me. He never pays attention to the shout-out I gave him.
Oh, you gave him already? Well, good. He got two of them. He ought to be really happy. He said it mean the world to him. So maybe that mean the universe to him. So, you know, got two shout-outs. Another commercial. This game might not be over until midnight. I want to get home in time to watch the Colorado Buffaloes tonight.
Tell me about Hunter Security.
Oh, I'll tell you, Hunter Security is awesome. That's Scott Hunter is running that place now. Buddy Hunter started the business, and Scott took it over and been in business since 1978. And just proud of the confidence they have their clients have placed in the ability to perform their electronic, investigative, and security-related tasks. They've gained the trust of organizations such as State of Alabama, Providence Hospital, Spring Hill College, University of South Alabama, SADS Healthcare, McDonald's, to name a few. Additionally, Hunter has gained the confidence of over 5,000 homeowners through the Gulf Coast. So not only do they do industrial and commercial, but they do residential security. Call Hunter Security, where your security is their business. All right, third and 17, probably.
16, they said. And he missed the tackle there.
Oh, Malone's got a lot of open field.
You got to contain.
Malone on the keeper down the sidelines, out of bounds. At about
all right, so we'll call a timeout here, I would think. 3 minutes 25 and still ticking.
Dallas Booth makes the tackle.
No idea why we're not calling a timeout right now.
Pirate Closet, we want to let you know they have cowbells with a
3:15.
I don't know.
They're going to let this run down as far as they can let it run.
Just do not sit under the press box
before they punt. Yeah, they may not. Yeah, they're punting. We got a big old kid back there about to punt.
Yeah. Well, they've got fourth and six, so
yeah,
smart move.
Oh, the ball was almost on the ground.
And that's their original punter back in the game now. I guess he's feeling better.
Yep. Yeah, all of a sudden.
Nice punt. Fair catch about the 20.
So, you know, on that last play on defense, Fairhope actually just ran right past the quarterback. Sometimes you go in there under a little bit of control. You know, he would have had to scramble. I don't think he would have had that big of a game.
Right.
2 minutes, 48 seconds to go in the half. That's plenty of time. We got 80 yards to go, but
yeah,
two field goals to tie up the game now.
I don't know if we can kick two field goals that quick.
No, I don't mean before half. I just mean in the game.
Well, I hope we can score a touchdown.
So, in other words, maybe one field goal if we don't have time to get a touchdown.
We can get it. We're going to get it. We'll get Preston Godfrey in open field here and outrun everybody to the end zone. A little motion. Reset. A little zone read, and maybe should have just went with the option. There's nothing doing up the middle there.
Yeah,
maybe
we're not
gain
getting
of one.
Much up the middle.
.230 and counting.
It'll be second and nine.
Still
for
got
the Pirates.
Two timeouts left, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe one. Maybe we have one timeout.
That's Preston Godfrey. Kind of hard to read, but doing our best as old people.
Passing.
The block. You got a block. Turn it up.
Get out of bounds.
Yeah, you got to get out of bounds on that.
Sanders Daniel
on the screen pass from Robertson.
Let's go stop the clock and set the chains.
Out about the 34-yard line. A first down for the Fairhope Pirates.
Get to him on the 34.
Daly makes the tackle, but a big Pirate first down. If you're interested in helping the Spina Bifida organization tonight, the leftover T-shirts are
203.
You can buy those down to the end zone. All proceeds go to the UAB Children's Hospital.
Clock running. Cost. Underneath two now.
Big gain. Still on his feet, out almost to midfield at about the 48-yard line of the Pirates goes Preston Godfrey.
Preston Godfrey, nice
the tailback
carry
for the Pirates with 151 to go, and just like that.
Of the Pirates and a Pirate first down.
Fairhope's got something going.
Yeah, good run right there by Godfrey, just seeing the open field and use a good peripheral vision, and once he saw the hole, he went straight upfield and picked up about 15 yards there. Need something down about 30 yards. Get us in the field goal range and maybe a shot to the goal line. Oh.
Well, he had nowhere to go there.
That was a jailbreak right there. And just three guys on him, but when he got the football.
About the 41-yard line, second down.
Forced us to use a timeout there, Jack. Our last one, I believe, of the half.
Yeah.
Among others.
A minute and 16 to go in the cap in the half.
Timeout ball by the Pirates.
Be a long second down.
I'd like to thank our Jumbotron.
At this point, you really
can't
play for, you know, you got how much time left, so you got to be thinking big chunks, not just enough to make an easy third down. You're going to have to get, you know, 20 yards here to give us a shot, at least a field goal, maybe on the next down or so, with no timeouts left.
Well, they're going to be coming after the Fairhope quarterback, so you've got to do something quick.
Screen pass.
Potentially a screen, potentially a draw.
The draw. The clock.
It's a clock burner, though.
Yeah, it's a clock burner. Something to the sideline, maybe a corner pattern with Daniels.
He's going to have about 2.5 seconds to get rid of the ball.
Yeah, the way it's looking. Yeah, they're going to be pinning their ears back and coming after us right here. But when they do that, you tend to get man-to-man coverage, and if you get somebody to break one, never know.
Got a couple of quick shout-outs.
Second and 17.
Got watching the first time from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Reggie Riley, class of 1985, says, go Pirates. Thanks for watching, Reggie.
Robinson looking to pass. Oh, and he was open. He got hit. should have been pass interference. That's there, and no call.
It'll be third down for Fairhope.
He had a good bit of time to get rid of that ball.
Yeah. Just try to hit him on a quick slant play right there. Would have picked up maybe 7-8 yards. Not really sure why you're calling that. I mean, at 7-8 yards at this point with a minute to go, doesn't really do anything. I got to get downfield. And that's definitely not going to do anything.
Well, and a minute left, and
they're going to be forced to punt. They got three timeouts left.
Significant gain on the play. It'll be fourth down for the
Pirates. Yeah, they're going to have to punt, and Foley's going to have a good bit of time. I got a shout out to Bryant Thomas and the 9 and under Pirates, who will be taking on Foley down at the Barnwell Sports Complex tomorrow at noon. Good luck. Good luck to the 9 and under Pirates.
So, who is Foley playing tonight?
I don't know who Foley's playing tonight.
Well, you just said.
The nine.
No, before
under.
That. Before that, you said Foley.
Huh?
Yes.
What'd I say?
You said Foley's going to get the ball back. You must have been looking at your phone when you were saying
I was talking about.
Kinda,
yeah,
exactly.
They were playing Foley.
And then you said something about Foley.
Probably did.
Hey, I got some score updates for you, Jack. 21-7, Mary Montgomery over Baker. Wow. And Foley, 21-16. Alma Bryant coming back.
Right about to lose my mind with the echo in this headset.
That's what it is. It's been echoing since the Foley game.
He's still here.
Wow.
Paratroopers, watch out.
Not my finest Pirate Nation Live moment.
Fake punt right here? No, we wouldn't do that.
Look for the blooper album.
No fake punt. Guaranteed no fake punt.
No. Oh, wow. What a kick.
That was a great kick.
And a great.
Oh, wow. You talk about a gift. It could have been potential game changer.
Wow.
They put the ball ground on about the 5 yard line. And we had three guys around it. We didn't get it. I don't know if we got a replay.
And that's why you always hustle down the field. That's why everybody has to run to the ball. You just never know.
Chase the
never know what's going to happen.
Till the whistle, chase the play. That's right. You're 100% right.
I'm going to tell you, Daphne is very, very fortunate right there. We don't have the ball first and goal inside the five. That was close.
Hey, it could happen again. Malone, drop it here.
49 seconds and Daphne's offensive line right now just taking control.
Yeah, they're owning us right now.
First down for the Trojans.
Yeah.
That right there was number
40 seconds and counting.
Number 45, Nick Clark. Wow, what a pass.
Pass is complete to Gardner.
We're playing safe right here. You know, got some deep safeties. Not
that's right.
Burnt deep.
And they called timeout with 26.4 seconds to go in a half.
Dallas Booth makes
wow. We could have had a bad. That was a potential gift. Did you see the Houston game last night with West Virginia?
I did not. No, sir.
Holy cow. West Virginia took the lead with 12 seconds left in the game. They threw a pass across the middle. Kid ran it all the way to the end zone, scored a touchdown with like 2 seconds left or whatever it was. Excessive celebration penalty, took a 15-yard penalty on the kickoff. Okay. They kick it off. It was more than 2 seconds. I can't remember how many seconds it was, but more than two. Houston gets the ball in great field position because of the penalty. They kicked it from the 15. So Houston got the ball in about the 45. Threw a Hail Mary with 2 seconds left. And the kid for Houston catches the ball in the end zone and wins the ball game with no time on the clock.
Wow.
All because of an excessive celebration penalty. Allowed them to get the ball and be able to throw it to the end zone. that just proves how important it is to keep your head during
keep your head in the game.
And, you know, play fundamentally sound. Not that that kid could have done anything about fumbling down there. I think that Fairhope kid just made a good play on the ball. Wow, what a pass.
Yeah. And the Daphne offensive line just did a great job against the Fairhope. We only had about a three-man rush, and they blocked us. He had all day to throw it. Yeah. And they may run out to half on this play. There's only 8 seconds. It looks like they called a timeout now.
The reverb's gone. When you're talking, I don't hear reverb, but when I'm talking, I hear a little bit.
I hear it.
Not bad. It's nothing like it was.
No.
Whatever
it's a lot better. What'd you do, Des?
Des? Man.
Did you finally figure it out?
He's been Googling over here. Oh, man. Look at him. He's happy.
Yeah, it's a little better.
I think Richard Brunson told him what to do.
It's not a total echo. It's just a little delay now.
Yeah.
And I'm so used to talking with that echo, I can't talk normally now. What? I can't hear anything. All right, testing 1, 2. That's better. Testing 1, 2. I can't hear it. Testing 1, 2.
What did you do? Huh?
Somebody turned the wrong knob one game, and Des didn't know it. And
look, I could have fixed it earlier, but he wouldn't let me mess with it. He said, don't touch it. So I didn't touch it.
All right.
Even though I was a sound equipment engineer for like 20 years, he still told me not to touch it.
Is that when you were a singer?
Yeah. Huh?
Is that when you were a singer?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
All right. So, Des, there's just like a slight delay now.
It's not as bad.
No, it's not an echo. It's just a delay.
All right, first and 10, Malone quarterback. Three deep safeties. A little prevent defense here. They're just going to keep throwing underneath passes.
And then
0.2
seconds.
They almost let it run off.
As soon as he puts the ball down, though, he should start the clock.
Were they out of timeouts?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it. That's it for the first half. We're going to pause. We're going to turn it over to the Fairhope High School marching band and the Daphne High School marching band. Enjoy the halftime show. This is Jack Burrell along with Dustin Wagner. We'll be back just before the second half kickoff.
You get the chance to make a difference to that, not only to that patient in terms of providing them the care that they need, but also the family, helping them understand what's going on and have some reassurance that the patient's getting good care.
We all have something good to bring to the table to take the best care of our patients that we can.
It just feels like family. It feels like we're taking care of family while we're here.
Fairhope in general has grown a lot, and I feel like Thomas Hospital is the cornerstone to our community.
We're able, you know, to form those relationships with families and spend time with them, which is really special that I feel here.
Not only does our community give to us, we give back to our community. We want to be able to provide the care that they are looking for right here in Baldwin County.
You can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of School Superintendent Eddie Tyler and Principal Fletcher Comer, Daphne High School is proud to present the sound of the Eastern Shore. The band is under the field direction of drum majors Brent Lacoste, Julian Kiesel, Brittany Swan, and Elizabeth Evans. This evening, the band will be performing their 2023 competition show, The Ring of Power, featuring the music of Howard Shore and musical soloists Julian Thomas and Carter Frey. Drum major Brent Lacoste, is the band ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the Daphne High School Sound of the Eastern Shore.
The ring had never come to me. Wish none of this had happened.
So do all who live to see such times, but that is not for them to decide.
Bound the gates, but cannot hold them for long. The ground shakes, trembles,
This evening's show is sponsored by the Road Church at Eastern Shore. The band would like to thank some of our sponsors for tonight's performance. Fairhope Pediatrics, Shattered Rage Room, Clear's Clinic, LCM Motor Cars, and Spriggs Enterprises.
Staff includes Madison Harry, Kendall Calhoun, and Nicholas Herboso. The band proudly presents their 2023 program entitled Fire and Ice. Musical selections include Dies Irae from Mozart's Requiem, the theme from The Frozen Planet, and Stravinsky's Firebird. Drum majors, Vincent Von Trobo, Meredith Bates, and Gustavo Aguilera. Is your band
ready.
On behalf of Principal John Cardwell, we proudly present the pride of the Eastern Shore, the Fairhope High School Buccaneer Band. Thank you.
We are ready. Try again. All right, we are ready to introduce our 2023 inductees into the Fairhope High School Athletic Hall of Fame. We'll introduce them, and they'll get their picture made with our principal, John Cardwell. First, Gray Adams. And step forward if you don't mind. It looks like you already have your plaque. So, Gray, step forward and show us your smiling face. Nathan Andrews, who is represented by his family tonight. Again, Nathan is on his honeymoon. Tell Nathan hello. Megan Dowdy Curry. Congratulations. Stu Fuller. Hey, Coach Stu. Hannah Legg. There she is. Toby Thomas. Hello, Toby. And while they're not out there at the moment, the entire 1983 and 84 state championship baseball teams. Our associates tonight, Dr. Robert Eubanks. Great guy. And the family of Carlos Yelding, celebrating his life. Congratulations to our 2023 inductees into the Fairhope High School Athletic Hall of Fame. All deserving, great people, one and all. Thank you very much. Do something a little different. You've seen it on TV. Looks easy on TV. But we're going to now have our Community Bank Challenge. Thanks to Community Bank for sponsoring this. Two contestants have a chance to win a $1,000 scholarship from Community Bank. The rules are very simple. The student who makes the most footballs into the Community Bank target in 30 seconds will be named the Community Bank Challenge winner. Tonight we have Murphy Creel and Melissa Fowler. So take it away down on the field and let's see what happens. What you call a moving target. Thank you. We have a winner.
Didn't even get finished with the challenge. All right, I guess we're back.
We
back this.
Murphy Creel won the Community Bank Challenge, and we'd like to thank Community Bank for sponsoring this fun event. Maybe we'll see it again in future games.
I guess
games.
Because of TV requirements, they're required to get that kickoff quick. They pushed him off the field with fundraiser.
Yeah, we
kicked it off.
We were watching the Community Bank Challenge. I was eating a hot dog. Dez was down in the stands somewhere, and
Susan Parnell.
Dustin was maybe paying attention.
We only have a first
a little
name
bit.
Grayson, another first name Ernest.
All right, Malone
Jennifer
back in quarterback
Baker,
again.
If you bought tickets to the raffle, pick them up at the tent, please, where you may have bought the tickets.
Kids, shifty little
first
running back.
Yeah,
he is.
The 38-yard line.
Our defenders are having a hard time squaring up on him.
It's like a little iron ahead, Hayward, or Miles Sanders, Boston Scott.
Once again, Bonnie Hindman, Sharon Brown, Susan Parnell, Grayson.
Shout out to
Jennifer
my
Baker,
beautiful, lovely,
of the raffle.
Skinny wife, Jessica.
Item. So if you purchase
she's your, watching tonight. I can't believe it. Says she's watching. She must be watching you or something.
My wife is watching tonight as well.
Wow, okay.
With our dog. She said she and the dog are watching.
So. There you go.
Hey.
A good night for us. First and 10. Trojans. Wow.
Thanks to everyone for hitting that goal of 10,000.
Nothing fancy there. Just giving it to him right off the left side. Nick Clark for another 10 yards.
Luke Gellerin makes the tackle. It'll be a first down for the Trojans.
Daphne through the air most of the first half, starting off on the ground second half. They moved a little early there,
yep.
Jack.
Going to back them up 5 yards.
Okay, we have a penalty on the play. We also have a split the pot ticket winner.
First and 15 for the Trojans. After the penalty.
After the penalty, it'll be first and 15 for the Trojans.
Another pass out deep. Wow.
Yep. He hauls it in at about the 40-yard line of the Pirates.
Yes, John Davis, the wide receiver, number 14. Got about 5 catches tonight already. I don't know if Malone's that big or if it is that 45 is just that little. You know, 45 looks like he's maybe 5'7", 5'8".
He certainly runs bigger than that, though.
Yeah, he does. Little fire plug. Good job by the defensive line there. No gain on that play. This officiating staff, I think this is the first time I've seen this actual crew handle one of our games. Done a pretty good job tonight.
Yeah, they have.
There's 14 again.
Daphne moves the chains again. Now at the Pirate 27. We're here early in the second half play. 9:30 to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, it was John Davis again on the reception. Thirteen seconds to go on the play clock. 10. They get it off a little reverse. Really more of a jet sweep. You notice, Jack, when they run that play, this a pitch forward instead of a pitch back. So if he does drop it, it's going to be an incomplete pass.
Right.
See a lot of teams going into that on the jet sweep.
Very short gain. I think they're going to say no gain there. Second and 10.
defense.
I can remember back 15 years ago, we used to run that play, and it was a handoff, and they'd hand it. And eventually, I guess they figured out, hey, if we just pass it forward,
that way 15-yard penalty.
Incompletion.
Yep.
Was that unnecessary roughness, maybe? The helmet came off of the Trojan.
Yeah, the helmet came off. Must have jerked it off. Personal foul, that face mask, probably.
Face mask, maybe. Yep.
Yep.
I didn't see the flag.
It had to have been on the sideline,
yep.
On their sideline. About a 4-yard gain there. You hadn't seen number 3 turn it upfield before the snap here. After we got penalized, a lot of people are looking for it. They kind of told him, look, you're turning it upfield a little early. Harbin getting his name called again. Been on a lot of plays tonight. He's open in the corner, and they're going to get it to him. And oh, overthrown.
Just a little out of reach. He tried to pull it in with one hand, couldn't quite make the grab. Good effort on the part of Daphne Trojan there.
It was R.J. Daly, the intended receiver. Had a step on us right there, and just a little bit out of reach by Malone.
And we've got it. We've gotten lucky on at least 2 passes tonight that have been overthrown that should have been 6.
Yep. We jump. We must not have gotten a neutral zone.
Yeah. 2 seconds, 1. They get the play off with 1 second on the play clock.
Oh, is that a horse collar?
Yeah, my gosh. Either a horse collar or a face mask or maybe a little of both right there.
Man, it looked like me on a dove hunt after I shot dove. There's like 5 of them falling down. I mean, that happens all the time when I'm hunting dove.
I bet.
Yeah.
Are you shooting them off a power line?
Yeah, out of a tree. All sitting on one limb. $400. Well, they didn't miss that call, did they? I think every official threw a flag.
I think Coach Carter threw the flag on that. Now it's unfortunate because it was 3rd and 8 prior to that.
Oh, he just
we stacked him
his
up
way
the line.
To the goal
denied
line.
Him.
They're not gonna give it to him. Saying he's short.
And, you know, the more plays they run, the more chance of a mistake being made or turnover possibly.
That's right. That's Clark again.
And I don't know how many yards Daphne has, but they've chewed up a lot of ground tonight to only have 9 points.
Going with a QB sneak, and they're going to give it to him. Touchdown.
Well, he earned it. He didn't get it easy.
No.
Daphne now with a 15-3 lead, pinning the point after.
I don't know if I'll go for 2 here. Put you up by 14. I don't know. See what he's doing. They're talking about it.
Well, 14's a good number. 13's not a bad number either. It's a touchdown, 2 field goals. And if you make the extra point, it's positive energy instead of negative energy.
Positive.
Yeah.
Oh,
high
snap. Got it.
So kick is good.
16-3.
7:20 to go in the 3rd quarter.
Maybe a little early to chase points at this point. So
I think so.
Yeah.
That's what I say. I'm a believer in positive energy in the game. If you miss the two-point conversion, it's negative energy. If you make the extra point, it's positive energy.
What's that? Here we go. We got a commercial on the field. Let's go to Thomas Hospital. We'll be right back.
As you know, we have a lot of volunteers who help make Friday night happen, and they should be introduced every week.
You get the chance to make a difference to that, not only to that patient in terms of providing them the care that they need, but also the family, helping them understand what's going on and have some reassurance that the patient's getting good care.
We all have something good to bring to the table to take the best care of our patients that we can.
It just feels like family. It feels like we're taking care of family while we're here.
Fairhope in general has grown a lot, and I feel like Thomas Hospital is the cornerstone for our community.
We're able, you know, to form those relationships with families and spend time with them, which is really special that I feel here.
Not only does our community give to us, we give back to our community. We want to be able to provide the care that they are looking for right here in Baldwin County.
Twice. All right, we're back. We're back, Jack.
Yeah. I got a shout out to Sanders Daniels' aunt and uncle watching in Dadeville, Alabama. Thank you all for watching tonight.
He kicks it deep. Chance for a turn here. Oh, he had a seam, too. If that kid doesn't make that tackle, it's him and the kicker. And I think he had a good shot outrunning the kicker.
Yep.
But it won't be that. It'll be first down, Fairhope, on the 27-yard line. We got to get points right here, Jack. 7 minutes to go in the third. Need some points. Something positive right here. Positive energy. Oh, that's a face mask. Face mask. Come
yeah, they got it. I was about to say, if I can see it from the booth, they had to see it.
Oh, no doubt. This line judge, I figured he was going to throw a flag, but. All right, we're back on webcam here.
Okay. Do you think there's a chance that maybe they're waiting a while to pull the flag because they're looking for other infractions maybe before they throw that? I don't know.
I have no idea.
A little slow.
Yeah, the field judge threw the flag there. The line judge had the best view of it, and he never threw the flag.
Well, I can see why it takes a while to get the flag out. He shoved the thing so far out of his pants. It's down by his knee, I think.
Yeah. Oh, there's Martin. He's got room. Still on his feet.
Martin on the pass reception.
Yeah, he's
fun
to
watch. Took the ball. I don't know if they're going to say he's down. They got the ball. They're going to say he's down.
Right. And Martin, he has all kind of moves. He's running backwards, sideways. I mean, just
breaking tackles.
Oh, yeah.
Plus territory now. Fairhope moving the football. Martin again.
Martin goes around the right end.
May have juked a couple too many times that day.
Hard to say if he should have taken that first hole there. I don't know if he could have gotten any more out of it or not. He's trying.
I'll lose one on that play. Second and 11. Just a quick
set pass there to the right side.
Picks up maybe one. That play hadn't picked up much yards tonight.
No, that's been a staple for the Fairhope Pirates for as long as I've watched them. Doesn't seem to as be successful this year as it has in years past.
Sanders Daniel on that last pass reception.
Sanders out wide. To the right side. Good pass. Still going to be well short of the first down.
Did he pick up on yards to maybe worth going for on fourth down?
Oh, yeah. You got to go for it on fourth here. It's a fourth and maybe five.
About five. It'll be fourth down and five.
Yeah. 34.
Too far for a field goal attempt. And
33-yard line.
Probably too close to punt.
Yeah.
I'd go for it.
Maybe run that option play we ran early in the game. That worked really well. Hadn't ran it again since. Oh, my goodness. Did we jump? We got a timeout.
It's not like Coach Williams to not go back to something that works. He's real good about it. If something works, he'll stick with it.
Oh, yeah.
He's not afraid to go back to that play.
Yep. So how you been feeling this week, man? You ain't had to go to Alpha Care or anything, have you?
Not yet.
No?
It's only Friday, though.
Yeah, it's only Friday. Yeah. I tell you, that place must be pretty awesome, mate. I've heard good things about them. They're accepting new patients now at Alpha Care. Where are they located, Jack? You see that on there? So we're by the high school, right?
Yeah, 210 Greeno Road.
Okay.
That's right there by the high school, right?
$35 physical still.
Not there.
Is that right? No? Oh, across Bayside Orthopedic.
Yeah. It's right there between Trustmark Bank and Centennial Bank.
Okay, Trustmark Bank and Citizens Bank. Gotcha. Good location. Right there on 98. Easy to get in, easy to get out. Home of the $35 sports physical. So if you got an athlete in the family and needs to go get a physical, I know softball season's right around the corner and we got girls need to go get physicals, go over there to Alpha Care. Urgent care, now open, taking new patients.
Yeah, there's a picture of the facility. It's a beautiful building there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there's a picture of it there. Yep. Good looking building.
I should have known. I drove right by there on my way to the game. Actually pulled in to their parking lot. Yeah, oh, yeah, right beside it.
I'd say it's tough to keep momentum going. We don't have much momentum tonight in many drives, and we get a little momentum going, and we get a two-minute commercial. It's just part of being in TV games. Now you know how the college teams feel when they feel like they're getting momentum going.
Exactly.
Screen, nope. I had no chance.
Couldn't quite get enough on it.
Looked like they were setting up a screen to Godfrey and then went out wide.
The receiver was open. He could have got a little bit more zip on the ball. Could have been a first down. And they'll turn the ball over on downs. And with 5:53 to go here in the third quarter, Daphne leading 16-3, they'll take back over at their own 33-yard line.
Jackson Robertson a little shook up on the play, and I think he's going to be okay. First and 10, Trojans from their own 33-yard line. Nothing fancy, just off the left side, a little sweep.
He doesn't go down easy.
Nick Clark.
Inside the Fairhope 30-yard line. They bring him down about the 27 or 28 of the Pirates.
Yeah, first half was all about the pass for the Trojans. And second half so far, with 5 minutes and 42 seconds to go in the third, has been all ground game with Clark. If we have a timeout or I think we had an injured player and he's going over to see Marley Carnevale, one of our fine trainers for Fairhope. And they're going to sack Malone.
That's a big loss.
12.
Big play by the Pirates there.
Marston Davison.
That took him out of field goal range for sure.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. That'd be a 57-yarder.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be out of range for Luke Freer, though, would it?
No. No.
We're mentioning Luke Freer. He's the kicker for Air Force Academy now, the great Fairhope Pirate kicker who kicked a 59-yarder. Was that last year or the year before?
About 2 years ago, maybe? Wasn't it? Yeah. Looking deep. Oh, it's intercepted.
It is intercepted there.
Great play by the safety. That's number 17. That's going to be Jalen Stanton. No, that's not. That's Daphne.
Dixon Davis.
Yeah, Dixon Davis. Wow. Great play, kid. It's a good read. Is that his second tonight? Who got the first one? I think it was Davis.
No, that was Nolan Phillips got the first one.
Nolan get the first one?
Yep.
All right, so if we got to get a little momentum here and get something going on offense. Give this defense a little bit of a rest.
All right. New life for the Pirates now. They need to get something going, though.
You have these winning tickets. Come up here, and we'll give you a free hat. Tickets are on the board.
He just has no time. Robertson got hit hard right there. He's getting up slow.
Well, the Daphne defense, they're having a heck of a game tonight, and the Pirates are having a time trying to figure them out.
Yeah, they're just running through our offensive line. I don't know if it's a scheme they're using or what, but they're just getting through the block quick. Jackson's maybe got a second and a half to get rid of the football before he takes a hit. Just all over him right there.
Yeah. He made something out of nothing there. He got a short gain.
Yeah, he just kept retreating about 20 yards back and then got it to the backfield.
Got about 3 yards out of it, though.
They're going to run that same play we ran on fourth down, see if we can't get it. Good
catch. He hauls it in right there. Big play by the Pirates.
Nice, yeah, that's a great job. All hands right there. Good catch. Can't see who that is. Is it 24, Jack? Danny Edgerly on the catch.
That's right.
Yeah, yep. Good job. Great hands. Good job holding on to the ball and continuing the catch as you hit the ground. Preston bouncing it, yeah.
Good cut by Godfrey there. Picks up about 8 or 9 on first down. Leaves up second and short.
All right, this is one of those downs where you can maybe go over the top like you were talking about earlier. Maybe look for a big play. If you don't get it, you still got a third and short. We got 2 minutes and 37 seconds to go in the third quarter. Official timeout. Oh, we got an injury timeout. It's like a possible cramp over there on a Trojan.
We're two hats down.
Yep.
All right.
Fairhope's got their best drive that they've had. Probably moved the ball more than they have the last several possessions.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, but thanks to the good conversion there on third down. Great catch. What about the approved facilities here, man? Jack, the new baseball fields over there in the east side of the stadium.
Right.
Look good over there.
New bathrooms over there.
New bathrooms.
Well, the city's growing so fast, and our youth sports, our baseball program grew by probably 500 kids in the last 6 or 7 years.
Wow.
It's just amazing. You know, I just look back, it seems like my son just finished playing Little League Baseball, and I coached there forever, and it's been 9 or 10 years, and it seems like yesterday.
I know. Believe me. This is my – I was talking to Coach Stu Fuller earlier, and he's coaching at Saraland now, but this is my 18th year. This year will be my 18th year as a assistant coach with Fairhope High School. 8 years in the baseball program and 10 years with the fast pitch high school softball program this year. So
thank you for that, Dustin. Thank you.
Hey, it's hard to believe. I don't know. Where's the time go?
Yeah.
It's unbelievable how fast time flies. Some of you young parents out there and teenagers and cherish every moment, every minute you have with your kids and these youth sports and just enjoy every second of it because it's just a blink of an eye, it'll be over.
Well, some of the youngsters when I moved here that were seniors in high school, they're over 40 now. it's amazing.
Oh, wow. Second and two, Jack.
And this has been a theme when we have a good gain and we have short yardage to get a first down, we've been going backwards. And
yep. That's been their recurring theme tonight on runs up the middle.
Yep.
Just haven't been there.
Just have not been there.
Number 91.
I haven't seen a quick pitch all night. Maybe a quick pitch. You got to do something to slow that rush down.
Yeah, number 91 and number 7 have controlled the middle tonight.
We went from second and two to third and five now.
Lambert and Durant. Oh. Oh, we got a rough of the passer.
Got another roughing.
That would have been a pick six coming back with a rough of the passer, but luckily 10 dropped it anyway. So
there was two possible outcomes. It was almost a pick six, and it was almost a catch for a first down.
Yeah. That's going to give us a first down. It'll bail us out there. And put us in plus territory.
They get out into Daphne territory, mark at about the 40-yard line. The first down for Fairhope Pirates.
I don't know if we've been – I think we've been across midfield three times tonight in their territory, maybe on offense.
Yeah.
Not many.
Probably three.
We need to definitely capitalize on this opportunity. 1 minute and 35 seconds to go in the third quarter, running out of time here. They had the screen set up, and it was just – oh, did he hit late?
It was a late, very late hit. The ball had already been batted down to the ground. And
somebody came up there and nailed him.
He did.
Our fans are not liking that call.
Second 10 for the Pirates.
Hadn't called Senator Daniels – name much tonight. He's due. Oh, Lord.
No, he got there a little early, but I ain't going to call it.
We had a man wide open down the middle of the field, but he just didn't have time to get it
to
him.
No, the Daphne rush is getting to the quarterback tonight, and he's just running for his life back there and having to dump the ball off before he's ready to.
He's going to have to go see probably a chiropractor or a massage therapist tomorrow or ice bath after the game for sure.
Near the end of the third quarter.
Third and 10.
He's definitely taking some licks tonight.
That's Edgerly again.
Well, he got enough yardage to put us in a fourth down situation that we'll definitely go for it at the 35 for the Trojans.
Yep.
Be fourth and five.
Ball on the 35-yard line. Fourth and five for the Pirates. Mitchell on the reception. Pete makes the tackle.
Fourth and five.
They're going to come after him, I guarantee you.
Yep. Good catch.
Great play.
Same kid.
Mitchell on the pass reception, out of bounds.
So 14. That's Tad Mitchell. Okay, Tad Mitchell on the catch there.
Yep. Picks up 15 yards there on 4th and 5. Moves the change, and Fairhope in the red zone. With 40 seconds to go, they'll get off one more play this quarter.
The Edgerly and Mitchell show so far in this drive.
And he's got some running room.
They try to strip it.
And that's how you effectively deal with that rush right there.
Oh, yeah.
The little screen pass.
They tried to set it up a couple times.
Right. They blew it up a couple times.
Yeah, they did. Jackson's got to learn to drop his arm and get that slot and try to get it under those guys. And he'll learn that as he gets more experience.
Right. And that second down play, handoff up the middle, just not there tonight. Not there for us tonight.
It is not there.
All right, that's the last play of the third quarter, and they'll swap ends of the field. We'll go to a commercial break.
All right, you pirates, load the cannons and ready the blades. There be trespassers in our waters, and it's time to pay the pirate. Lower the colors and hoist the red. Take no prisoners, show no mercy, and give them no quarter.
Can't schedule an illness or injury. That's why AlphaCare Urgent Care is open late every day. The care you need when you need it. Locations in Spanish Fort and Fairhope. AlphaCare Urgent Care, changing the way healthcare is delivered on the coast.
What makes Thomas Hospital special? Our team. Our team makes us so special. We have great physicians, great staff, and great volunteers.
We serve a lot of needs. We impact a lot of people. Baldwin County is the county everybody wants to live in.
People, when they talk about Thomas, they talk about the experience. They talk about how well we interact with the families. And I just think it's a wonderful place to be.
Over the years, I've come back to Thomas Hospital because it feels like a family. Thomas Hospital is a family-friendly environment who cares for you all the way from the time you're born all the way to the end of your life.
My favorite thing about working here at Thomas Hospital is the underlying attitude of the staff, where there is an understanding that we're all kind of looking out after each other.
All right, we appreciate that. We appreciate all of our sponsors, especially Thomas Hospital, our high def sponsor. Alpha Urgent Care, Hunter Security, Thomas Roofing, and we're going to get to Thomas Roof at the next break.
El Mexicano,
home of Pirate Nation Live, yep. El Mexicano.
Second down and goal.
Orthopedic Sports Medicine.
Oh.
I don't know who jumped there.
Later.
We may have jumped.
Laid us out. False start.
And there you go, second and 10, and
shoot yourself in the foot.
After the penalty, it'll be second goal from the 50. All right, let's get something going here, Pirates.
I guess if you're going to jump, might as well make them pay for it. What 91 was thinking for Daphne. That's just a jump ball and double coverage.
Robertson's passing the corner. Is that Amir?
Yeah,
up
he wanted the ball.
I was wide open.
Every time I don't throw it to you, I'm wide open. Oh, Coach Carter did not like that. Just a teaching moment there.
Yeah, he's probably going to say, Amir, we may go back to that play. Don't advertise to the whole world how open you were.
That's right. Well, believe me, I guarantee you, Jackson, if he could have got it to him and thought he could get it, he would have got it to him.
All right.
Nobody wanted a touchdown more than him, I promise, much as he's been getting hit tonight. That play just not going anywhere.
No, and I think you kicked the field goal here. You're down by 13. Yeah, a touchdown and two field goals.
Fourth and goal.
McKellar comes out. One for one tonight. Fairhope looks to make it a 10-point game.
Kicking from the left hash. Going to be a 28-yard field goal.
Picks up long enough.
Looks good.
It's straight enough, and it's good. 11:03 to go in the contest. And Fairhope cuts Daphne's lead to 16-6.
Guys, I know there's a couple storms out in the Atlantic right now, and I'm hoping they don't come anywhere near us. But if they do, we have got someone who can handle all of your roofing needs if you have any problems, and that's Thomas Roofing. Since 1968, Thomas Roofing has built a reputation for excellence by adhering to the highest standards of performance in every phase of the roofing process. Whether it's installing a new roof or replacing an old one, with their rich history that continues to shape our future, Thomas Roofing continues to evolve to meet the changing needs of the growing and more advanced customer base, primarily along the Gulf Coast. That's Thomas Roofing, where they believe integrity, quality, safety, and customer satisfaction and innovation are their core values. Give them a call for all your roofing needs. That's Thomas Roofing in Fairhope. All right, here's a kick by Fairhope. Good coverage by the kicking team there.
Nice return by Zion.
Hey, you're going to get a turnover right here deep in their territory, and you never know what could happen. We got a full quarter left, 10:55 left in the fourth quarter. At some point, down by two possessions, Jack scores. We got to get two scores. You're going to have to make something happen on a turnover. We're going to have to get a turnover or, a three and out or a couple three and outs.
We've got to hold them on defense, and we've got to hold them on crucial third downs and not make any penalties.
That's right. Yep. Got to stop Clark. They're going to give it to him again. And we didn't stop him there.
No, he gets past the first line of defense and picks up about 11 yards. Got a shout out to one of our biggest fans, Jet Pollard. He says, we're sounding great from Pittsburgh. Go Pirates. Thanks for watching, Jeff. Always appreciate giving a shout out to you, man.
Jeff is in Pittsburgh?
What he says, sounding great from Pittsburgh.
All right, another first down run, getting 10 yards. Just Clark, it's the Clark show here in the second half.
Yeah, and Fairhope just doesn't have an answer for Nick Clark right now. You know, we handled Foley's offensive line pretty well. They're big guys. I mean, they probably average 270, 280 across the line. And Daphne's pretty big. I don't know if they're that big, but They are sure making some running room.
For
Clark, number 45, just continues to have big gains against the Pirates.
Number 96 has got his hands full with number 76 every play.
Jep says he's visiting his wife's cousins in Pittsburgh.
Okay.
All right, Jep. Well,
that's a good husband.
A good one, man. I tell you, good man. He's such a great guy.
Don't go too far. No, it's old Jep we're talking about. I love him. He's one of my bestest friends. A good guy. We don't get to spend a lot of time together as much as we used to, but there's none better than Jep Pollard, I promise.
I know it. He's one of the greatest Black Bear fans I know.
Second and 13 for the Trojans. There's Clark again. Held him for about 3 yards that time. You know, talking about Jep, just give him a little shout out and to tell you how good a man he is and his kids. You know, after his kids got finished playing baseball and youth sports, Jep and Wynn and Oliver, I think, helped a little bit. They went back and coached a couple youth baseball teams after their sons were done.
Oh, I remember.
Contributed back to the community and gave all his time, you know, a lot of his time to try to help them. And just a great guy. And get a chance to see Jep, too.
Oh. They almost had Clark in the backfield. He breaks free and picks up a few, but it's going to be fourth down at about, say, five at the Fairhope 35, 36-yard line.
All right. We may get one of those breaks we need. It's 8 minutes to go in the fourth.
Got to get a stop right here. This is a pivotal play of the game. Right,
stop them here. We get good field position.
Plenty of time left if we stop.
He'll kind of get us to jump. Nope.
Oh, no, they're going to go for that.
Well, they don't get it.
Good coverage by the Pirates there. Big stop. Big play. Look, right. They're fired up, too.
Yeah, the coaches are on the field trying to get his team fired up.
There we go. That gets the booth fired up, too. That makes our job a lot easier.
Yeah.
Hey, don't forget about the Booster Club Casino night coming up Saturday, October 28th, $125 for a couple, $70 for a single ticket. It's going to be held at the James P. Nick Center, a.k.a. the Nick Center, at 1 Bayou Drive in close to downtown Fairhope, Alabama. Yeah, I guess you could call that downtown, but it's not in the center of downtown. It's just on the north side of town.
Hey, got a shout-out from Adam Gambino saying the Gambinos are supporting the Pirates.
Look at that catch.
Oh, what a catch by Sanders. I told you a few minutes ago it was time to call his name. Yeah, he ran out right there on the 35. Here's a replay. And Sanders, just a good catch going up. We missed it on the
When he goes up and just takes it away from the defender.
Desmond getting on his cameraman down here. They tried to catch the play, but Sanders just a little too fast.
He jumped out of the picture.
That's right.
Just jumped out of view.
Yep.
It's not their fault, Des.
There's Preston, got wide open field. Hey, it worked. I told him to run it off tackle. There he is. See? That's the first time that play has worked tonight, no doubt.
Rips off about 13 more yards down to the 23 of the Trojans. And just like that, the Fairhope Pirates in business, knocking on the door. 7:07 to go in the quarter, or 7:07 to go in the game.
Yep.
Hall of Fame night tonight, and also Spina Bifida night.
I think, oh, we moved. He's trying to stay still. Too late for that. You moved early. Yep. I think that was Kane right there that moved. 52. Yeah, I think one of the young lady that sang the national anthem did a really, really good job. I think she was one of the Spina Bifida kids honorees there. And she just did a great, great job singing the national anthem.
Yep.
First and 15. Got single high coverage. We hand off again.
Godfrey fights his way inside the 25-yard line.
Got somebody tried to get us, but Jack is quick with that kind of stuff. He pick it out, man. Hey, he came up with most of those things, so you ain't going to get him. All right, second and 10, and another penalty, and another one.
Yep. Fairhope saying offsides.
Yep.
We'll get our five back.
Yeah, they got it back.
Good old Andy watching there.
Yeah.
Nice try, Andy.
Yeah.
Whoever you are.
Oh, Handy Andy.
That's all we
trying
do.
To just, get us.
We just give those numbers to the Fairhope police, so
that's
don't
right.
worry about it.
That's right. Oh, no, a fumble.
Look at
oh,
that.
Look at that play. Talking about a Mahomes play.
Yeah. All day long.
That was wow.
Brian Martin. Talk about a shovel pass.
Yeah, yeah. That's quick thinking. All right, so it's a setup up first and 10, just outside the 10-yard line, so we can still get a first down without scoring. There's Preston again. Going to have a chance.
Good gain there.
Down
by,
to the five.
By Godfrey. Big gain.
Wow, this clock is running fast. We're already down to 4 minutes. It was just at seven. I mean, just seems like a few seconds ago. We got to hurry up and get in the end zone here.
Well, we got a Daphne player down. And
they didn't stop the clock.
No.
.440 to
That's
go in the game.
One of their standout players still on defense, too, number 91. He's having a big night.
So
shaking
score,
up on the play.
You score here, do you onside kick or you just kick it and hope to hold
kick
them again?
If you score right now, you kick it away. Play the field game.
Go, Preston. Go, Preston. Down to about
He's
the two.
Hard.
We got to hurry, though. We got to get it. Let's go.
Yeah.
It's you close. Got he did not get the first down. Third and short.
That's okay. You got them on their heels. Run the play.
I say you fake it off tackle and hit Sanders right behind the linebackers in the back of the end zone. Sneak him out right here, right in the back. He's lined up off tackle. Oh, we'll give it to Godfrey. And he's not going to get it. It's going to be fourth down.
Did he not get a first down?
I don't think he got it.
Well, that's
I
close.
I think he's close. Did they give it to him? No, they gave it to him.
Yeah,
first and goal.
First down. First and
right
goal.
Right at it. First and goal.
1 yard line.
Yep.
3.5 minutes to go.
At this point, you can't.
What if you just fake the handoff to Godfrey and let the quarterback just go in behind him?
Yeah. Going to give it to Godfrey.
Didn't
Doesn't get
in.
There. I mean, play action right here would totally.
The ball boy's not happy down there. He threw his hat in the ground.
Yeah. Play action, coach. Let's go.
I wish we had a video clip of that now.
2 minutes and 50 seconds to go in the game. I think. Coach King called a timeout. He didn't like the formation. I mean, they're selling out on the run right here, down here on the goal line. I think he run a little play action right here and in behind the linebackers. And I think it'd be an easy score. But I don't know what Coach has been seeing up there. He's here. He's got to play for this.
You know, we mentioned the great Fairhope kicker, Luke Freer. Mm-hmm. You never know who's watching. I just got a shout out from Luke Freer's parents that are watching the game tonight and listening. And I know that it makes them happy. And I had no idea that you guys were watching the broadcast tonight, but we're happy to give a shout out to your son. And, you know, just as you're proud of him, we are proud of him, and his community is proud of him, and thank you for his service as well. And I was out in Colorado Springs just a few weeks ago, and I wish I had had time to call him up and see if he had time for lunch or a dinner, but I was on the run a lot and didn't have time for it.
Colorado Springs.
Beautiful cities, big city now. It's growing, growing tremendously, like a lot of places. But
right.
Ella Shedd, Grayson Van Sice, Sadie Claire Smith, Addison Walsh.
Well, we had our coaches beating and parents beating for the Fairhope High School softball team Thursday night, last night.
When will the season kick off?
We'll kick off in February, and going to have a good club this year. I don't know how far we'll get. Our pitch is not going to be quite as deep as it has been in recent years, but we got a good group of girls, and I'm really excited. Can't wait to get it started.
Well, like I said earlier in the broadcast, Dustin, thank you for what you do and coaching the youth for so many years here, 18 years, I believe. That's going to be almost had it.
How's your play action pass? It was there.
Well, we got two more plays to punch it in. Naked bootleg.
Yeah. I don't know if he have time.
They wouldn't expect it, I guess.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I don't know if you just go ahead and kick it here and go ahead and get your three. You still got to get another score anyway. And don't, you know, not come away with nothing. Because if you don't get this, you're not going to have a chance anyway.
I'm going to punch it in. Toss it to the left.
There's your keeper. He got it. He got the pylon.
He got the pylon.
You called it. It wasn't a neck and bootleg, but it was a quarterback keeper. Quarterback sweep.
Jackson Robertson
with an athletic play. Stuck the ball out and knocked the pylon over before he went out of bounds, and that's a touchdown.
Absolutely. And just added another dimension to his game.
Yeah.
2.5 minutes.
What do you think? I think you got an onside kick it here.
We have
two timeouts.
Yeah, two timeouts. That's a tough call.
The way Nick Clark's running the foot. What the heck, Charlie?
Okay. And they counted the kick.
Look at Don. Don's shaking his hand, and telling
Holy
no more.
Mackerel.
You're done.
Folks, I hope you saw this from home or wherever you're watching Pirate Nation Live. But, I mean, we were in formation. It was a live
Fix
play.
Fix the kick. Fix
Charlie
the snap.
Charlie just fired the cannon.
Fires the cannon.
Hey, just whenever. Fireworks going off. Daphne's player's jersey on fire. I mean, come on, Charlie.
I tell you,
something.
Hey, you know,
they all went to the ground. We should have just ran a 2-point conversion.
And they're going to throw a flag on that. Probably they're throwing a flag. They just convened. They're going to make them come back.
I don't blame them. I don't blame them. I'd be unhappy if that happened to us.
I don't know what the call is going to be. Unsportsmanlike. Possibly, or
delay. Well, it didn't delay the game.
No,
that's going to be an unsportsmanlike.
Let's see what they're doing here.
When was the last time Charlie got a penalty? You think?
I don't know. That's wild. Let's see what the call is. Maybe it had nothing to do with the cannon. But why would you convene that long after the kick? Unsportsmanlike.
Unsportsmanlike.
On the offense. Yep. I figured that's what it's going to be.
So, Charlie Lang gets flagged for 15 yards.
Coach Carter is going to be upset.
You know, I got one of those. I was at one of my dad's game. It was a college game he was coaching. I was on the sidelines. and the other team was kicking off, and they were offsides on the kickoff. And so the ref runs by, and I just yelled, "Hey, they're offsides!" And he came back and threw the flag on
me.
Oh,
wow.
And I was a spectator. That didn't go over too well.
No. No. I can't believe those officials called that, though. Coach Carter's staring hard at the officials.
Well, I'm not surprised because they kicked the ball, but what if we had ran some kind of trickery?
True.
And so you don't know what's going to happen. Yeah. I mean, they were kind of in shock if we just
the Daphne players
tossed it
were.
Out and ran it
right.
over two if it was a tie game. So you have to keep the game.
Ooh. Yeah.
You know, in check. It's just like when a guy's running off the field, but they don't quite make it off the field, so they get a penalty for 2 minutes on the field. There's a line you just can't cross. McKellar kicks it through. He kicked that one further than the last one.
Man, that looked good. 35-yarder.
Yeah, his leg's getting stronger and stronger.
Charlie's going to be in the doghouse. Coach Carter's going to call him in to the doghouse after the game.
Oh, I can't wait to see him. Oh, I can't wait. I'm going to text him right now.
Yeah, give him a text. I had never seen that before. I don't know if it was a misfire and, you know, sometimes they won't go off when they're supposed to, and then all of a sudden, boom, you know, just it hits that powder. Luckily, Don wasn't standing in front of the cannon when it went off. Because Don reloads it for him.
I got some fans watching from Las Vegas. Says they are proud of their little brother, Brady Nelson. Sorry.
Uh-oh, we get it? We got it? Did we get it? I think we're going crazy. Let's see on the offside kick.
Both sides are claiming it.
No signal.
Let's see who has the ball.
No signal. Both – oh, Daphne's got it. We had a good shot to get it, and maybe we lost it at the bottom of the pile. Trojans come out with it nonetheless. 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the game. 25-second clock. I mean, you cannot give up a first down here, plain and simple. You've got to stop them on three plays to have a shot or get a turnover. And it's going to be the Nick Clark show all day long. Crowd the line of scrimmage right here. And key on 45. And there it is, Nick Clark. Second down is seven. And we got a timeout. It's 2:21. All right, so one thing we got to watch out for is they know we're going to be keying on Nick Clark because for Malone pulling it and trying to go around the outside on a read play. So our ends are going to have to really play with discipline and make sure they don't take their eyes off of nine as well and let our outside linebackers do their job.
I got a shout-out to Dixon Davis's grandma and grandpa Davis, a shout-out from Missouri this week. But they'll be in person next week. And Dixon with a big interception tonight. Boy, would it be great if he could get another.
Yeah, it'd be real great. But I don't think they're going to pass again. I think the passing is over for Daphne.
You know, you say that, but I've seen teams with a minute and a half.
Oh,
all they had to do was take a knee with the lead.
With the lead.
And throw the ball.
Yeah. Alabama did it. It's, you can see it happen for sure.
It happens occasionally, but they've got a pretty good running game, and they don't really have a need. If you don't have a running game and you want to get a first down, maybe, but, you know.
And there's Malone pulling it. I told you. There it is, and we're going to stop him short.
He got about five.
He pulled it on the read play, on the read, little option. He could either hand it or keep it. All right. Biggest play of the game. Not even close. This is it. It's 2 minutes, 13 seconds to go. We'll be out of timeouts after this play. If we stop them here, it's going to leave us with about a minute and 50 seconds on the clock. I don't know if I'm – do you pass here, Jack, if you're Daphne on third down, third and four?
No.
Or you just give it to Clark and take your chances, and if he gets it, he gets it. If he doesn't, they punt it deep.
I give it to Clark, yep.
Yeah.
100%.
You don't go for it on four downs here, do you?
No, never.
No? Not at midfield?
No. No way. No, because all we'd have to get is about 15, 18 yards and we'd be field goal range.
True. Yep. The way he's kicking it tonight, yep. he's kicking it good tonight. I'm with Jack on this. I think you're going to see the Clark right off tackle, same thing they've been doing all night, unless Malone pulls it again. This is it. Little sweep play out to Clark, and we've got him back in the backfield, yep. And that's going to be a fourth down. That's
huge
the play we needed.
Huge play.
Wow. Here's a replay right here. They just give a little quick pitch to Clark. And a good job by our end getting off this block. He'll lose a couple yards.
Fourth and six for the Trojans.
Huge play. That's Harbin over here. Harbin making that tackle in the backfield. Patrick Harbin been on many plays tonight.
Got a shout out to Jamie Pippen, a former player in the class of 2005. I want to thank y'all for watching.
Clock still running, a minute and 25, so I was off on the time. Daphne calls a timeout to keep from getting the delay.
This game's not over yet, and I tell you, we've seen a lot of big moments in this game, and we could come back.
Yes, we can.
We could do it.
Don't forget about the play where Amir Adams was – I don't want to say it real loud because the Daphne coaches are right upstairs, but Amir Adams wide open on that one play.
Right.
Maybe hit that play again.
I'll tell you what, if they kick off and you get Brian Martin back there, he could go all the way. Never know.
I don't think they kick – they got to kick it out of bounds, I would think. No chance of a kick return. I wouldn't want –
You know, it's high school football, and they practice those things, but it's not like professional
football.
They can
football, do it. It's not like they can execute
that's
it.
All they do. These guys have to go to class and then practice and then go back home and study and do homework. And when you're a professional, your homework is watching film and thinking about those things. So anything's possible in high school. That's what makes it so – that's what makes it so much fun. It's not always predictable. Mm-hmm. I can't get the word predictable out of my mouth because of the
delay.
Yep.
The delay.
No, it's more like the delay.
All right. Hey, a couple of high snaps and low snaps. You never know. We've already seen a couple tonight. Punter's made a good job fielding it.
How about a block?
Perfect snap. Oh, and he
faked it. He faked it. We're going to get him.
Oh, we're going to get him.
Oh, huge.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, this my goodness.
What I tell you?
What
I tell you?
What? Okay. What are you doing?
So they lost. Coach. They lost yardage. We have a great kicker. And let me tell you what's going to happen. We're fixing to beat Daphne because of, like you were saying earlier, they wouldn't pass. Why do they do what they do? Why did they do that?
What
Thank you.
In
they
the
just handed us. They
world?
Just, they just gave us a gift.
They called a timeout to do that? Yeah. Are you kidding?
Yeah.
Holy cow.
I'd say a lot
oh,
more on the subject,
wow.
I'm afraid people
Coach
might.
Coach King, me. Woo. All right, minute and 18 seconds. Let's go.
Yeah. Get about 20 yards or 25 yards and kick it.
There's a good pass. It's Edgerly. Hold on to the football. Yeah. Blow the whistle.
Yeah, exactly. That's okay. We don't.
A minute.
We got five.
That's,
of
a,
the
that's
an
offsides.
That's
no
okay.
call? Okay, we'll take it.
Who was that on the other side of Brian Martin? Almost like pitch it to me.
Yeah.
Like a hook and lateral.
Right. 50 seconds.
Now, this is going to get really, really interesting.
Need to get to about the 25-yard line. Oh, no, 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 no! He just threw a pick.
I don't know. I don't know what that was about. And the euphoria turns to grief.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Wow. That's all I can say. Wow. What are we doing? You need a field goal.
What was it? Second and one?
What are we doing? You need a field goal. You need 8 yards. You're in field goal range. You tie the ball game up. We're throwing it 25 yards downfield in a double coverage. Goodness. Well, maybe they'll fumble this snap.
Or maybe they'll try to run it.
Yeah. Like Miami did.
Good game. Well fought game. Well, they gave us a chance. They sure gave us a chance. I thought we were going to win it. I did.
Wow.
When they made that mistake, I thought it was we were going to come out the winner. Tough break. Really tough break.
Why is Coach Carter? He's really upset about something.
Yeah, and that's going to be the ball game.
I must have missed whatever he's upset about. He's going after. He's just going to go. Congratulate Coach King, but wow.
What a ball game, Dustin. What an ending. It's kind of like Daphne the whole game until the end. Fairhope came alive, came back, pulled it within 3 points.
Yeah.
Held them, finally. Fake punt by Daphne. And we're driving, and then game essentially ends with a turnover. Back to Daphne. They take a knee, run the clock out. Wow. Heartbreaker right there. Heartbreaker for sure. Dustin, I surely have appreciated it. Appreciated our time tonight.
Yeah, it's been fun. It's been fun. You never want to lose. I enjoyed a great football game, but coming out with an L on the losing side is never fun. But what a game.
Well, I think we continue to grow. We played a very tough team, a very physical team, you know, against one of our arch rivals. And I saw our quarterback grow up again, you know. Mm-hmm. He scored the touchdown there towards the end of the game. And he was on the run the whole night. He was under a lot of pressure tonight. But he's learning. He's learning to handle that with each and every game that he plays. And having Martin back, that brought a new dimension. But what a heartbreaker.
Yeah, good hard-fought battle on both sides. And neither side laid down and kept fighting to the very end. And we just came out on the short side tonight.
Well, folks, that's going to be it for Pirate Nation Live tonight. We'll see you next Friday night. Who have we got next Friday night?
We have got Baker Alma Bryant. Alma Bryant. Baker? No, I think it's Alma Bryant. We got Alma Bryant, I believe, next week, then Baker, and then Briarwood. So that is what we got.
And that's on the road, so make sure you tune into Pirate Nation Live.
Huh? We're going to check. It's either Alma Bryant or Baker. Yes, Alma Bryant. I was right. Go ahead, Des. Tell him. I got it. Huh? Yeah. First time ever. I've been right. I was right.
Now, we got most of the calls right tonight.
Yeah,
by the way.
We did. Except for the numbers. We didn't get the numbers.
We can't see the numbers, though. That's not our fault. All right. Look, get a 15-yard penalty like Charlie did tonight.
We did not. Yeah, we could have, but we didn't. Yeah. So, well, it's been a good night. And
I wanted to get one right there at the end, but I didn't.
Jack's been fun.
All right,
and,
bro.
And Des, thank you.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
And, thanks, guys, for everybody watching. And
watch
go
us
Pirates.
Next week. We'll be playing on the road at Alma Bryant. So when you can't be in the stands, be in front of your, you know, your TV, if you're streaming it there, your computer, your phone or whatever, just be sure to turn into Pirate Nation Live and watch Dustin. Are you going to be on the call next week? I'll be on it.
I can't remember.
You don't
to be
know?
Honest.
Oh, my gosh.
I can't.
You're killing me.
I'm 51, right. man.
Until then, it's good night and go Pirates.
All right.